You know what time it is, Steven?
What time is it, Brian?
It's time for the Mission Prep Pre-Game Show. I am Brian Stanley. Joining me to my right, Steven Hodges. To my left, my cameraman, Thomas Bowden. The three-peat is back together. The Trinidad, the Trinigo, whatever you want to call us, as captains meet at center field for the coin flip. Your captains for the Royals are going to be Connor Lopez, Luke Terry, our homecoming king tonight, Drew Harrigan, and Gabe Rodriguez. For the Righetti Warriors, captains are going to be Malachi Langley, Ethan Sunderhaus, and Alex Nerez. We appreciate you being with us tonight for the pregame show. Coming up just minutes is Mountain League action between your Mission Prep Royals and the Righetti Warriors of my hometown, Santa Maria. Steven, I was at the pregame lunch with the team today, and I got a chance to talk to Coach Schuster, and I asked him what the Mission Prep Royals' strongest strength was coming into tonight against the Righetti Warriors, and he said it was their defense. What does this defense bring to the table that will assist the Royals in achieving a win tonight?
Well, you look at this defense, and it's an aggressive defense that's able to bring the fight to the offense. It's really aggressive across the line of scrimmage, and it's resulted in a really low-scoring situation for the Royals. The Royals have yet to allow 100 points across their entire schedule. They've yet to breach that. And you might be saying, all right, 100 points, what does that really mean? Well, no other team in league is that low. Everyone's at least over 120. The good defense is around 120, 150. The average defense is over 200 points right now. So you talk about a team that's doing more than what's expected. You know, two standard deviations from the mean. That's where the real outliers are. That's where this Mission Prep defense is, especially when it comes to scoring and being able to really limit opportunities for the opponents.
We'll be right back.
Mercedes-Benz San Luis Obispo, with over 25 years of experience and 5 years serving the SLO area, Mercedes-Benz of San Luis Obispo wants to help you get behind the wheel of your next vehicle. So next time you're in the market for a luxury car, keep it local with Mercedes-Benz San Luis Obispo.
Get a head start on your New Year's goals with Kennedy Club Fitness. Locations all over San Luis Obispo County. You've got classes, sauna, steam room, tub, and a heated pool. It's where I work out. It's Kennedy Club Fitness.
Welcome back to Mission Prep Pregame Show. I'm Brian Stanley. With me is Steven Hodges, back from his assignment with Cal Poly. Welcome to have you back, Steven.
Ah, glad to be back.
And how was your trip?
It's good. You know, despite going out to Bozeman against the number two team in the nation at the time of playing, we'll see. There's a lot of action going around the Big Sky. We'll see how that ends up at the end of the weekend. But As far as everything goes, you know, Cal Poly played well. I always enjoy a good trip to Montana. It's a beautiful area of the country if you've never been there before.
And we have two teams tonight looking to get a win. The Royals looking to get back into the win column after a tough 10-3 loss to the Eagles last week. The Righetti Warriors looking for their first win in league, coming in tonight 0-5 in league play. Only one win under their belt all season long.
And that's really a sign of a hungry team more than it is a team that's, you know, oh, down in the dumps, all that. This is a team that's upset. They've lost some very close games. Outside of their games against AG and St. Joe, all of their games, all of them, decided by less than a touchdown. This is a team that knows how to hang around in the game, knows how to play competitively. They're going to be hard to put away. And this is a team that's hungry for a league win. They're better than that 0-4 record that you see on the league schedule. They're fantastic, and they've, you know, beaten teams like Justin Garza earlier this year and played Bakersfield very competitively.
And here's the kickoff taken at the 21-yard line by the Righetti Warriors and quickly brought to the turf is the return man, Adrian Mondal, and it's going to be a 1st and 10 for the Righetti Warriors. First possession of the night, final home game of the season for the Mission Prep Royals.
Well, final home game of the regular season. There's still a chance that they would return to Mustang Memorial Field during playoffs should they have the opportunity to host. Where the rankings are sitting right now, that looks very likely. Regardless of how it goes down the schedule, they will likely be hosting at least one home game here come postseason.
And stepping to the line in a very tight formation.
Love it. Look at all those tight ends. Four tight ends. Oh, well, here we go. And one wide receiver coming on late.
And a late wide receiver to the left side, Damian Mraz. And Mraz in motion. And the carry coming out to the right side cannot find any room to turn the corner as Malachi Langley being chased out of bounds by Ethan Orozco.
Expect the Warriors to be a very run-heavy team. They've been having issues recently, particularly in Mountain League play, throwing the ball. It's not been a healthy situation for them. So I expect to see a lot of emphasis on the run. And, you know, as much as it's throwing stones in glass houses, Mission Prep, very run heavy as well. So this is probably going to be a game that's decided in the trenches. Expect a lot of heavy sets by both sides.
Quarterback tonight is Gilbert Maguire. Hand off once again to Langley. Langley shakes one defender. Trying to turn the corner, get outside the numbers. Gains a few yards on 2nd down. Back between the sticks looking for a 3rd and short now are the Warriors.
Jaden Noziel doing a good job coming in on that run fit. Bounce out to the outside by a lot of the different linemen. Langley found his way to the outside. Noziel met him at the line, made that tackle for a short gain. It's a really important skill for safeties to have in the modern landscape of football. The run game hasn't gone anywhere, but the safety's involvement of it has gone way up.
Maraguay, the quarterback. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Fakes the handoff, decides to keep it himself. He's going to come up short as he's met at the line of scrimmage by a body of Royals. That defensive line coming up short, a 3 and out for the Righetti Warriors. Here comes the punt unit.
Well, McGree is a fantastic running quarterback. He's got now 39 carries on the year. He's going to be a guy that's going to factor heavily into this run attack for the Warriors. So expect to see more of that. A lot of the read option type of situations as they get the ball later in this game.
And that ball is on the turf. Able to pick it up is the punter. Gets it off. Noziel waves it off. Doesn't want to touch it as it rolls out of bounds at the 30-yard line. And a decent recovery by Johnny Castillo, the punter.
Well, Royals going to get the ball here. As we said, a very run-heavy offense. We're going to see some of their big guns here early. Last week against Arroyo Grande, there was not a lot of room up front. They walked away with only 3 points. The defense played very well, but the offense was just not able to find the running lanes that they had in earlier games, especially late. They really got clamped down on. So I'd expect to see a big push to try and get the ball going early for this offense.
And a handoff out of the backfield to Drew Harrigan. Harrigan out on the right side, and we have a flag coming out of the backfield from the white hat. And he replaces the flag at the 29-yard line. of the Royals. I imagine this is going to be a holding call if he's placing it at the spot of the foul.
Yeah, that earthquake you may have felt in slow was not anything from the ground. That is just, I think, Schuster's eyes rolling around in his head right there. A lot of flags last week in Arroyo Grande. And here, starting out, first play of the first drive, they're moving backwards from another flag.
And that puts them at first and 20. And the play comes in with quarterback Thomas Glenn. Glenn working from a shotgun position in motion.
And
another whistle.
We're now one offensive play, two flags. I think this was a jump along the line of scrimmage. It's a sign. Oh, this is going to go the other way. This is going against Righetti. I thought I saw some movement for the Royals, but definitely something that the Royals want to avoid. There's a lot of penalties. As you start looking towards the postseason, as we've already mentioned it once in this broadcast, penalties are one of those things that can make or break a game against more evenly matched teams.
Four offensive plays into this game, and we already have 15 yards of penalties. And driving forward with a dive is Drew Harrigan, trying to get back in between the sticks, and does just that. It's going to be a third and 10 for Mission Prep here. We're in the first quarter, 10 minutes to go, live from Alex G. Spanos Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field on the campus of Cal Poly.
Jacob Nelson, one of those two-way players for the Warriors. He's going to feature in on both defense and offense. On defense, he's a fantastic safety, defensive back, guy that's going to be implemented a lot in the passing game. On offense, one of the two wide receivers on this team that has three touchdowns on the year. So he's going to be a big one to watch, number one back there.
Glenn working in the shotgun. Fakes the handoff to Harrigan. Passes deep over the middle and can't get it to it is the receiver, Luke Terry. And Luke Terry had the afterburners on trying to catch up to that ball, but that ball had some heat on it.
It's a deep post. He had the inside leverage, everything that I was looking for. And that ball was just a little out of his grasp. And I think it may have just been a case of an overexcitement. It's a very good spot to connect. A lot of room for that ball to go. And just a bit of an overthrow there by Thomas Glenn.
And I had my counts off just because of the penalties. We're now at third down and 10. Because that was a second down and 15. There we go. We're all set. We're now at third down and 10. I thought it was third down last play, but we're on track. Let's go. Oh, that ball comes loose. Thomas Glenn able to fall on it. But that is a bad snap, resulting in some bad yardage. And the ball is back at the 15-yard line. A loss of 15 yards is going to be a fourth and 25. And the punt unit comes out with Thomas Glenn.
And just mental mistakes. That's all that drive was. Had a penalty early on that backed him up behind the sticks. They were able to get some of that back. But that snap to go backwards on a critical down, that you can't be having that. That's something that they're going to have to tune up.
Thomas Glenn delivers the punt, solid over the middle, dropping in and bouncing around just before the 50, down at the 48 of the Mission Prep Royals. And the Righetti Warriors get a second look at it after going three out on their first drive. We're in the first quarter, 8:45, scoreless between these two squads in Mountain League action. Mission Prep football presented by California Fresh Market and driven by Hyundai of San Luis Obispo. And Steven, before I forget, our first quarter.
Mercedes-Benz, San Luis
I'm making
Luis
mistakes
Obispo.
Already, Steven. Our first quarter presented by Via Automotive. Their family taking care of your family is their motto.
Well, last time the Warriors were out as a three and out, with two runs by Langley and one by Murguia, the quarterback. So we'll see if they mix things up a little bit more on this drive.
In motion. Keeping himself, Muraguaya, and pushing back. Well, typically I would be calling a rugby scrum. I had somebody incite me on some information. That is not a rugby scrum. That is a rugby maul.
Well, there you go. Not a lot of rugby clubs on the Central Coast. I know that Cal Poly's got a fantastic one, but I couldn't tell you the difference.
A rugby scrum is where they start with the ball in the middle, and the ball, that's where they start the play in a scrum.
Yes.
But when the guy already has the ball and he's being pulled a million directions on second down and 7, the pass over the middle completed from Maraguaya out to number 15, Derek Reynoso, And that's a first down for the Warriors here, moving the sticks inside the 30 now.
And a beautiful play downfield to make that catch and throw. Then immediately tackled down by a Royal, who I got my Royal roster updated today, and it looks like it's changed again. So apologies to that. I think it was Chant Morrissey. Not on my roster, though. We're in
21 with the carry as we are adjusting rosters. Ethan Sanderhaas with the carry. Getting out to the 25.
Armand Clayton getting in on that tackle as well. Armand Clayton has been fantastic along the defensive front. You talk about what makes a good defense, and you said earlier in the broadcast about how Coach Schuster thinks that the defense is really the thing that they're doing the best. It's not one player, and I think Armand Clayton's going to be one of those guys that is one to keep an eye out for these Royals.
Second down and 8. And pushing forward to the right side is the running back Langley.
Number 13, Malachi Langley on the carry.
And Malachi with a short game, bringing up a third down and medium for the Warriors.
Number 15, David Kellar.
And we have a timeout on the field taken by Mission Prep. We'll take the timeout with them, and I'll finish my story when we get back.
Mercedes-Benz, San Luis Obispo, with over 25 years of experience and 5 years serving the SLO area, Mercedes-Benz of San Luis Obispo wants to help you get behind the wheel of your next vehicle. So next time you're in the market for a luxury car, keep it local with Mercedes-Benz, San Luis Obispo.
So as we're still in the timeout here at Alex G. Spanos Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field on the campus of Cal Poly, our score is 0-0, 6:52 on the clock in the first quarter. It is 3rd and 4 for the Righetti Warriors. And quickly to wrap up my story about the rugby mall, Father Russ let me know about that at lunch today because he was a rugby player.
Yeah, rugby is one of those sports I like watching rugby sevens in the Olympics. I need to learn more about it.
Pass out to the left side. Able to stay on his feet is Langley. And Langley gains a couple yards but comes up short. And that's going to be 4th down and 3.
Yeah, this is must-stop territory for the Royals. They play a low possession style of offense where they're trying to have as few drives as possible between the two teams by chewing up the clock and really controlling the ball. So every drive counts, and this is must-stop territory because if you let one in here, you're not sure when you're going to get the chance to equalize, and you're not sure how many more chances the Warriors are going to have to build on that lead should they get it.
4th down and 2. Warriors going for it. Merguez keeping it, and it looks like it's going to be a turnover on downs.
Yeah, they're pointing forward as he went down. I think this is going to be, they're going to move the chains on this one. It's going to be a first down.
Okay, close enough to move the chains. I'll agree with the referees this time as the ball is sitting on the 17-yard line right where it needed to be to get the first down. That is a close one.
In that case, it's the line judge looking at the football right to the chain on the far sideline. He can see the relationship between the two, and he can point the chains forward even if it's right on that line. Chant Morrissey making the tackle. I believe that is Langley going up the middle.
And Langley getting stuffed on first down. 2nd down for Righetti now. 6 minutes to go here in the first frame.
Of course, the Langley name, a famous one in the greater Santa Maria Orchid area, is St. Joseph Knight. Darian Langley was there for a long time, and he made some MVP conversations while he was there. So I'm sure the younger Langley looking to do the same.
Pass deep, looking for it, knocked away by the defender, Luke Terry. Intended for Righetti Warrior Josiah Coronado. Damian Mraz, the intended receiver.
And Luke Terry doing a good job sticking with the wide receiver. Mraz was trying that lean back that you get a lot of times. It's kind of a form of offensive pass interference that's accepted of, hey, I'm going to fall backwards, and if you're in the way, oh well. Luke Cherry got around that, knocked the ball down. Good knockdown to save the touchdown.
Looking to throw it is the quarterback. Out of the pocket on the run. And Champ Morrissey chasing him out of bounds. As I believe we have our number situation sorted out. Champ Morrissey wearing number 34 tonight. Previously wearing 70 on the roster. And I believe moving back to 79 is Armin Clayton.
Yeah, it's the case where I believe the home jerseys are still on the way and the road jerseys are here. But fourth down and a big one. I think they're going to keep the offense on the field. This is close enough that even in high school you'll consider a field goal. But the Warriors coming out aggressive. They want to try and get the momentum on their side in a road game.
Maguire keeping it himself, throwing out. And on the coverage, Jaden Nozil. Moraz, the intended receiver, the incomplete brings up a turnover on downs as that was fourth and short for the Righetti Warriors.
A little bit of a miscommunication. Looked like he was trying to get Moraz to move back towards the boundary so he could throw him open. It's good coverage by the Royals. Not a lot of places to go, but not a well-placed ball. So Royals will get this back in the shadow of their own goalpost. They need to get the ball moving quickly to get out and give themselves a little bit of room to breathe.
Second possession for the Mission Prep Royals. First and 10 from the 9-yard line. And we have flag coming out from the far sideline in front of the Mission Prep bench. And they're saying it's against the Eagles. Excuse me, against the Warriors.
If they're still pulling flags against the Eagles, that'd be impressive. They're playing San Ynez right now.
I'm having post-traumatic stress syndrome flashbacks of flags at Doug Hitchin Stadium. Pushing forward, looking to get more yardage on first down, following the flag, getting about a half yard. Is Drew Harrigan.
And Drew Harrigan just running off the left tackle there, getting the yardage that has allowed to advance Abercrombie on the tackle. He's their leading tackler at 36 on the year coming into this. And he's the type of guy that you really want to avoid if you're trying to decide where you're going to go on the defense. He's got two defensive touchdowns, one from a strip six that is recovering a fumble and returning it for a touchdown, and one from a pick six from an interception. He's not someone you want to target.
Second and four for Mission Prep. And the line pushing forward, trying to get that first down, trying to find some mountain air here in San Luis Obispo. And that brings up third down and short for Mission Prep. Ball spotted at the 19-yard line.
Right into the core of that Righetti Warrior defense.
Oh, they're giving them the first down. Excuse me. Sorry to interrupt.
Yeah, they're going to get first down, and right now Righetti's forced to sub. Looks like one of the Warriors injured on that play. So we're going to see a little change up here. Number 26 coming out of the game, that's Adrian Mondel. And coming on in his place is going to be Brain Amba. And looks to be at that free safety position. So going to be, again, as we talk about, modern defense is that safety position is a very big player when it comes to run stopping. That's what Mission's trying to do right here, establish that power run.
Glenn with deuce receivers to his left side. He's chased out of the pocket, trying to avoid the pressure. But the big man coming in for the sack, Jordan Isako.
And Jason Isako with his second level speed to just get after the quarterback. That's always the funny thing about defenders. You're trying to play that game between you don't want to be able to be pushed out of the way, but you want that speed to chase down the quarterback. Isako showed a good balance between the two, fighting through the middle of the line where there's a lot of big bodies in front of him, and chasing down Thomas Glenn when he's in trouble to get the sack. That's a beautiful sack by the nose tackle.
Thomas Glenn working from the shotgun, single receiver in the back with him. Looking to throw those quickly out. And the receiver with it. And quickly brought to the turf after getting the mountain air first down. And that is Vinny Orlando, the junior, with the catch.
One pass,
Van Orlando making the simple play, getting the ball in his hands and making the first guy miss. And you can do that as a wide receiver, everything opens up for you. The world is your oyster because you're automatically open in space by being split out wide, and suddenly nothing but green anchors ahead of you. Big game by Vinny Orlando.
Tonight's Mission Prep football game is presented by California Fresh Market and driven by Hyundai San Luis Obispo. Single receiver to each side for Thomas Glenn. Souza in motion, right to left, handoff to Harrigan. Harrigan turns the corner, got the wheels turning. The freight train's moving down the tracks, and he's got enough for the first down, and that is a Mountain Air first down. And the Mountain Air is a family-owned specialty outdoor retail located on the central coast of California. Since 1975, they've been helping people of all skill levels enjoy the outdoors. Check them out today in the Marsh Street Plaza in downtown San Luis Obispo.
Look like Clipperton, Gabe Rodriguez, and Souza all getting fantastic blocks on that left side as they shifted the strength at the start of the play to kind of flip the script on the defense. Allowed Harrigan to get a big lane to the outside and just run straight down the sideline for a huge gain. That shows off Drew Harrigan's speed as well as the blocking ability of these Royals up front.
Good to see the running game working for the Royals tonight. Thomas Glenn throwing once again out to Vinny Orlando. Orlando taken down at the 28-yard line. A big catch for Orlando brings up a second and short. And I say, Steven, a big change to see the passing game or the running game come in because they only had 81 yards last week against Arroyo Grande as a team, did the Royals.
Well, Malachi Langley coming in at corner. I think that this is going to be a situation where they're trying to adjust who's on that field side. The Royals just switching hash mark to hash mark, using that open space. That's where they're finding the soft areas in the defense, is that open space. It's been whichever side they're going to.
This Thomas Glenn throwing it into the corner. Luke Terry nearly comes up with it.
It's Gabriel Foster there, the intended receiver, running on the field side. It's a little go route to the left side. The Royals really enjoying the field side of the play. I mean, you talk – there's a lot of things that coaches look at as far as strength goes. Which side of the field the ball's on, where there's more players in relation to the ball. You often hear, you know, strong side, weak side. It's usually which side the tight end's lined up on. You know, there's a lot of different ways you can play with it. Right now the Royals are playing with that space. So they're on the right hash mark. They've been pushing towards the left side while the ball's on the right.
Thanks for the correction on the intended receiver. Souza in motion, left to right at tight end. And a jump at the line. Fingers are pointing in from both sides as the official comes out to make the call. And it looks like this one, according to the way the official standing, is going to go against the Eagles. And as they count off five, I want to let you know that Via Automotive's motto is "Our family taking care of your family." And Via Automotive takes it to heart. The Via Automotive auto and body repair shop has both the experience and the equipment to diagnose almost any repair problem that you can think of. Proud supporters of Mission Prep Football.
Did you know in Aztec culture, the eagle is considered the warrior of the sky?
I did not know that.
Well.
Now I do.
Because that penalty was on the Warriors.
Did I say the Eagles?
Yeah.
Oh, my bad. Still thinking about the Eagles, having that stress of the penalties as Harrigan bounces off the defender. Mraz trying to get some extra yardage. And I'm all over the place with names now.
Yeah, that's why it's on the Mexican flag, I believe. But don't take my word for that. Go to your local libraries, I suppose.
Or
Drew
Wikipedia.
Harrigan testing the boundaries. I mean, local Wikipedia is wherever you're at. It's not as good as a local library. Your local librarian's got a degree for a reason. Anyway, Drew Harrigan bouncing onto the outside, finding a little bit of room. I think that's really where they want to try to get him in this game. Going through the middle has been effective. I think that's going to be something that's going to be later in the game plan. Right now, the speed of the Royals, something that we don't advertise a lot, starting to come into effect.
And another whistle here in the Via Automotive first quarter. As this quarter has come to a screeching halt, it seems like.
Another encroachment.
We might need some mechanics out here to adjust the time.
Well, it's something that's really tough for the teams that are playing Mission Prep. They love playing with the cadence. They have that hard count when they get down into the stance. They set and drop the hand down. A lot of times that's enough to bait the defense. We've seen that a few times in this game. Just happened again right there for the Warriors.
Second down for Mission Prep and short. Thomas Glenn rolling out, chased down, being chased down by one defender, and he throws this one out of the pocket, and Caden Flores chasing Thomas Glenn down.
It was a smart play there by Thomas Glenn. Just got to the outside and threw it out of bounds. Intended receiver was Souza down the field, but rather than trying to make anything happen there when you know it's either the boundary or the defender that's going to get you, take the yardage that you're going to get for free, which is back to the line of scrimmage, throw it out of bounds.
Ball spotted at the 17-yard line, the left hash mark, third down and short, right up the middle to Drew Harrigan, and that locomotive plows his way into a first down, a Mountain Air first down in this Via Automotive first quarter.
Jacob Nelson needing to wrap up the entire helmet of Drew Harrigan to pull him down to the ground. That's not a comfortable feeling, but it's effective. It's kind of a legal face mask that's happening. I'm surprised that there's not some sort of look at the rule book there with how much targeting has been redefined over the last few years.
We're under 5 seconds now here in the final seconds of the first quarter. Thomas Glenn intercepted if the play counts. Reception is good for the Warriors on the interception, as thrown away by Glenn.
Adrian Mondel.
And
with
Mondel.
Heads up play. A desperation throw forward. They're going to say it hit the ground from the looks of it. Incomplete pass, but a good heads up play by the Warriors as that ball hit the turf right before going into the hands of Adrian Mondel. The Royals will keep possession as they head into the second quarter.
If nonetheless, Mondel did a great job trying to sell it.
I mean, everyone did. You thought that was an interception. The people in the box saw it as an interception. The crowd did. It is a good sell by the Warriors, but the referees did not agree.
And at the end of the first quarter, we are scoreless between the Royals and the Warriors. We'll be back.
If ever I would leave you, it wouldn't be in summer.
We'll never leave you either, especially not in summer. Hi, this is John Via, and that's my son Tom singing. The average age of the car on the road today is at least 12 years old. The older the car, the more TLC it requires, especially during summer. So now's the time to come in for a free battery and alternator check at Via Automotive. The summer heat can be brutal on your car's electrical system, so let us make sure everything is working right. If you do need service, remember that our technicians are iCar and ASC certified, which means they know your car from bumper to bumper. At Via Automotive, we'll never leave you, whether it's spring, summer, winter, or fall. And that's a promise. Look us up online at via-automotive.com or call 781-3925. Via Auto Body and Automotive. Let our family take care of your family. Nicely done, son.
We enter the second quarter by the sake of grace of the grass. The ball hit the turf. Royals maintain possession. Second and 10 for the Royals. And Jaden Ozil with it. He's looking for the end zone and finds the goal line, crosses it. Touchdown, Royals. Royals on the board. First play of the second quarter, making an impact here. And that touchdown brought to you by KD Capital Mortgage.
Great end around by the Royals. They set the edge on the left side, and then Jaden Ozil is able to show off his speed. One of the fastest Royals on the field just gets going forward, puts his foot in, and bends that around, and then finds the pylon untouched, if not literally, virtually. Beautiful run by Jaden Ozil to open up the scoring in this game.
And out for the extra point, the hold, Vinny Orlando. Castrovizin in for the kick. Through the uprights, off the net, and it is good. With 11:55 in the second quarter, Royals lead the Warriors 7-0. And that touchdown again brought to you by KD Capital Mortgage. Another trip to the pay dirt for Mission Prep. And as always, the touchdown presented by KD Capital Mortgage, helping you find the right mortgage product for your needs and your properties. Visit them at kdcapmtg.com to learn more. And we have a kickoff presented by Sunset Honda here, Steven.
Well, last time the Warriors had the ball, they moved the ball very well and then ended up just running out of gas on a couple fourth down attempts. They got the first one and then turned the ball over on downs the second time. So the Warriors not necessarily as far out of this game as the score shows. I mean, this has been a very tight game. The Warriors very nearly led this on the last time they had the ball. It's up to them to, you know, remember what they were doing and that this game is still very close. It's very hard to keep that upbeat mentality after the streak of losses that like one that Righetti's had this year. So if they're able to bounce back in this one, it could be a very tight game to the buzzer. We've talked about how all but two of their games so far this year decided by a touchdown or less.
Cash Trevisan in for the Sunset Honda kickoff. Visit them for 0% APR before it's too late on all new 23 Hondas. And here's the return. Trying to cut across field. Does just that. Trying to find the edge. It's Mraz. Mraz finds the edge. Excuse me. Amba. Excuse me. I'm struggling with that one, Stephen. I apologize to his mother.
Very specific. Flag on that play during the return. I imagine that he's going to lose some of this, but still a good return. It's always about finding the blockers. Oh, this is going to go against Mission Prep. This looks like they look like it's an illegal block sign. Referee's back is to us, but this is actually going to add on. I don't know how you get a block in the back as the cover team, but that's what they're calling over the PA as well. So he's going to go deep into Mission Prep territory. This is a wonderful return. And the way special teams is so important. It's often scoffed at by people when you say, hey, Team X, Y, or Z has good special teams. Well, this is what can do for an offense. The Warriors are going to start with great field position to start this drive.
And you mentioned the PA. PA announcer Jared Alley, former PSN announcer. Broadcasted with me at Napomo High School.
Yeah, did a great job.
And a slow but delayed handoff, and we have a hold as Langley hits the turf at the 50.
I love the effort, man. If you're going to hold like that, that was one of the most obvious holds I've seen in a while. But it's going to end up coming for nothing as Langley ends up going down for negative 10. So they might decline this just because it's going to be a minus 10 anyway, and you get the down.
As Langley slips at the 50. Wave it off, Coach.
There we go. The official wave off there by Coach Schuster out on the field. And, you know, that's
Coach is like, no, I don't want it.
Yeah. You know, don't mark this off. I think they're actually getting more yardage from the tackle for loss than they would have if that's pretty close. But that down making a big difference. And, you know, as a coach, you always tell the O-line, like, whatever it takes, just make it happen. If you're going to hold big. And we're laughing because it's pretty clear. But, you know, that is the type of effort that O-line coaches like to see. Look, if you're going to hold, he's slipping back there anyway. Just get the hold because, you know, we could lose the down as well as they did right there.
A flag at the line coming from the side as well.
This is just another game.
I'm having nightmares. It's not even Halloween yet. Friday the 13th was last week.
Yeah, it's spooky season. I mean, that's how it goes. It's all your nightmares coming around right now.
And the run. Oh, big hit delivered. Oh, my goodness.
Hey, Ethan Sunderhouse on the run for the Royals.
And Cash Moreau delivering that hit.
Moreau with the tackle. But that is a good run going forward. He had a lot of momentum behind him. But they're still well behind the sticks. It's still about 3rd and 17 if I had to count it out here. So this is where you're going to have to rely on the pass game. Pass game has been inconsistent for Righetti through this year. Coach Russ Pickett's been doing a good job trying to stay balanced, trying to give both sides, you know, some ability, but they've been turning the ball over a lot through the air. So it's going to be Cash Carter, the quarterback, on this play.
Carter looking to throw. Fires deep. overthrows his receiver. The intended receiver was Jacob Nelson. And in on the coverage was Luke Terry.
Yeah, just to give it an idea, Cash Carter's only got one interception, 8 touchdowns. He's much more of the passing quarterback for these Warriors, as Gilbert Mariga is much more the running quarterback. He's run it a lot more than Cash Carter as far as yardage goes. But 6 interceptions, no touchdowns on the year for Mariga. So Cash Carter, I expect to be out there on the passing situations.
Castillo with the punt. Line drive into the hands of Nozio at the 19. Nozio weaving through the line. He's out to the 30. He's got some room in front of him. One man to beat, and that is the punter, Castillo. And trying to chase him down is Abma. And that is a touchdown for Jaden Nozio. No flags on the field. 81 yards to the barn, Jaden Nozio.
Yeah, don't chase Jaden Nozio, man. You're just going to be back on your own sideline tired when you do so. He's so fast. No one was going to catch him as soon as he found that lane. Cut back against the grain, through the cover team, found a couple blocks, and then was gone to the house. Jaden Nozio, with his second touchdown of the night, he could be up for some post-game considerations. We always have our player of the game. This is a fantastic start for the Royals, largely on his shoulders, due to that speed that he loves to show off, both on offense and on defense, and as we've seen tonight, special teams as well.
And that is our first punt return of the year for Mission Prep. And Cash Trevisan in with the extra point. And we are 14-0. Mission Prep leads here, following 2 touchdowns in the second quarter for Jaden Nozio. 9:58 on the clock. We'll be right back with more Mission Prep football presented by California Fresh Market and driven by Hyundai San Luis Obispo.
Family is ingrained in the core values of Mission Prep. So when picking cars, why not stay with family? And that means Hyundai San Luis Obispo. Yup, Hyundai Slow, located right on Auto Parkway off of Los Osos Valley Road, keeps it in the family with the Mission Prep familiarity involved. So go check out Hyundai Slow today for quality vehicles, a friendly team, and professional service at every step of the way. And tell them the Royals sent you.
Welcome back to Mission Prep Football on PSNtv. We are live from Mustang Memorial Field on the campus of Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Your Mission Prep Royals lead 14-0 over the Righetti Warriors, 9:58 in the second quarter. And Crash Trevisan getting ready to boot this one away. And Langley with the return at the 14. He's trying to find some room up the sideline, and he's chased out of bounds by the Royals. And chasing him out of bounds is Ethan Orozco.
You know, you don't like seeing the extra pushing and shoving after the play like that, but I will say, as far as, you know, where the Warriors are at, you do want to see a little bit of that fire. It's very hard to allow a special teams touchdown, because especially when it's punt return, you want to have that chance to kind of regroup as an offense, sit down, talk things out. Well, you allow a touchdown, and then you're right back out there. You don't really get that mental break after a pretty poor drive last time.
And we have a timeout on the field taken out by the Royals. We'll take timeout with them. We'll be right back. Mission Prep Football continues.
California Fresh Market is more than just your local grocery store. A full-service deli featuring premium boar's head meats and cheeses, handmade take-and-bake pizza, fresh salad and olive bar, gourmet cheese department perfect for any occasion, sushi rolled daily, organic and locally sourced produce, wild-caught seafood, choice prime and Snake River Farms American Wagyu beef, artisan sourdough bread, and full-service health and wellness. California Fresh Markets, the best on the Central Coast.
Welcome back to Mission Prep Football, presented by California Fresh Market, driven by Hyundai San Luis Obispo. First and 10 for the Righetti Warriors. Hand off to Langley. Langley trying to escape the line pressure, but does not, as Lucas Elmerich right there to make some work of him. No gain for the Warriors.
Not sure what to make of that yell there. I don't know if that was celebration or frustration as he's coming off the field here. Nowhere for him to really go. Caught up in the backfield, made a couple balls miss, but taking a second to regroup as Russ Pickett going to be working hard to keep his Warriors focused on the game. Keep that energy going in a positive manner as we saw some pushing, shoving, and now some yells of frustration on the sideline.
And the blitz from Connor Lopez right up the middle slows the offense, and pushed back is the running back, Mondel, with the carry, Adrian Mondel. And that is a short loss. They're going to give him forward progress to the 34-yard line, but a loss of 3 on the play.
That's what a good fire out along the line looks like. They got the offensive lineman moving backwards, just hips lower than the hips across from him. That allowed no room up front to move. Connor Lopez had a clear hole to get to the backfield, bounced the play backwards, and ended up being a big tackle for loss for the Royals. As all started from good fire out from the D-line, coming out low, on time, and physically. So there's going to be a delay game from the looks of it.
A whistle from the backfield with a flag. Yep. Yeah. That seemed a little fast.
Back judge may have had that a hair quick. I think you're right on that one, but they weren't even lined up by the time he was reaching for that flag.
They're lined up after a loss of 5 more. And the pass out to the right side completed to Cash Carter. Excuse me, to Damian Mraz.
Mraz got the ball, started looking upfield. By the time he was there, there's navy blue all around him, just a wash in the sea of Royals. Nowhere to go as he was racked upon the waves of that sea. And that was just good run tackling by, it looked like mainly Jaden Noziel coming downfield and breaking through the blocks to make that happen.
Castillo with the punt back into Noziel's range. But Noziel's going to let this one roll out of bounds. And it goes out at the 34-yard line. And the Royals will start with it first and 10 at the 34. The second quarter presented by Hyundai San Luis Obispo. Check them out for all your car buying experience needs, from your financing to your routine maintenance visits to your purchases of genuine auto accessories. They're there to support you in your ownership experience. Hyundai of San Luis Obispo, quite different entities.
Yes.
Hyundai. As this program is driven by Hyundai of San Luis Obispo.
Yeah, two different nationalities, Honda Japan, Hyundai Korean.
I did not know that. Now I know.
There you go.
And the handoff to the back, Drew Harrigan pulled down at the 40. And leading the charge on that one, Ethan Brown, the middle linebacker for Righetti.
Yeah, it looked like Armin Clayton again, working off of jerseys, not one-to-one based on what I got off Max Preps this morning, but good block out there by the right side, by the right tackle. Pretty sure it was Armin Clayton making that space available for that 6-yard run. Not a lot of ways to get to the running back until he had already gotten that forward momentum, then he was pulled down afterwards. As much as Drew Harrigan will get the yardage, you know, as an O-line push up front that made it happen.
Glenn under center. That seemed pretty fast.
As the Warriors faithful mocking the "you can't do that" chant of the Royals, which, you know, I love the sarcastic chant back, but, I mean, you guys have had that way. It's one-sided, you know. Anyway. Delay a game, I think you're right. I think there's something a little short on that clock, because that's the second time that we've looked at that, and it's just mentally not making a lot of sense. I didn't see the arm go up. I didn't see any of those warning signs, but then again, I'm not normally watching the back judge as the teams are getting lined up.
And a pile of bodies develops at the 30-yard line.
Yeah, Jacob Nelson in on the tackle for the Warriors. A good physical hit. We talk about how to channel that energy they're getting. They're a very highly energized, excited team. It's managing to get that going the correct way. That was a good hit by Jacob Nelson after the defense wrapped up. Finish it out, make sure there's no forward progress. Then bring up a third and long.
Third and 9, the ball spotted at the 35-yard line. Handoff, reverse, the old switcheroo. Jaden Ozeal trying to find some room. And Jaden Ozeal collecting a couple yards. Ball spotted back at the 35.
There, it's the Warriors firing out well. It is a combination of Adrian Mondel and Jordan Sacco up front, making sure there's no room for that reverse to happen. The reverse is supposed to be happening right behind the center, but they're so backed up that they're trying to avoid the footsteps around them, and it messed up the timing. Nazil never had a chance.
And the punt sent away by Thomas Glenn takes a bounce in favor of the Royals down to the 27-yard line.
A good stand by the Warriors, going to get them the ball back here. Last time they had the ball, they ended up marching, backwards and didn't really get where they needed to go. So Warriors going to have the ball here. They're going up against a very stout Royals defense. But, they still have a lot of things going their way. They've had a little bit of chance to recharge with the offense outside of, obviously, the two-way players. This is a good chance for a mental reset and to really re-energize this offense and get going the right way.
First and 10 for Righetti at the 27-yard line. And a quarterback, Cash Carter, he's looking to throw this one. He's being chased down, and he dumps it out of bounds into the hands of Aiden Finley standing on the sidelines.
And good rollout, just knew where the first down marker was. That's all you need. You don't need a eligible receiver when you're outside of the pocket like that. Pursuit outside of the pocket, throws it down. Finds the first down marker, gets it out. That's one of the rules. If I were made Grand Poobah football, I feel like you need to have an eligible receiver at least on your sideline or around where you're throwing it when you throw it out of bounds like that. I feel like that should be an intentional grounding with where modern football is at.
Warriors step to the line. Carter, the quarterback. Student section getting loud for mission prep. And a flag for a delay of game.
I think that one was pretty accurate. Yes. There's been three now. That's one that I think they took their time getting out of there. But last couple, little tight. I think it's just a case where the back referee has a tighter frame when he's hitting the clock compared to some others. There's a lot of give in when you start that clock. And this guy going to be very tight tonight.
Second and 15 with the ball, running it right up the middle. Weaving his way through is the running back, Langley. And Langley with a good gain on second down and 15 back between the sticks with a 7-yard pickup.
You talk about the pain that a offense has when they're marching backwards like that. Well, this would be a third and very short had that stayed between the sticks, had that not been backed up due to the delay of game. So this is a situation. They got to hurry up. We know that this is a tight count. I'm watching the back judge as much as I'm watching them now. Hands up. 4-3.
Pass completed out to the tight end, Alex Narez. And that is a first down, gaining 9 yards for the first down. And they needed 8. So a good awareness by Cash Carter to throw that pass. He has 8 touchdown passes this season.
There's a little arrow route there to the tight end. Those are the types of routes that you can adjust for the chains of, hey, you're going to bend it like this. You're going to bend to the first down marker. That's exactly what that route looked like.
Carter with 2 receivers on his near side. Hands off to Langley. Langley, a small little back, slips through the line. And that is an 8-yard pickup for Langley. A solid pickup for the small back.
Ethan Rosco having to come in and make that tackle. Langley getting a lot of momentum going forward. Talked about the danger that this Warriors offense has. It can get going when it gets going. And right now, they've got that rhythm. They've got that flow. I'd be trying to go tempo if I were the Warriors right now. If that's in the system, which sometimes in high school it's not, try and keep this flow going as fast as you can.
Mission Prep leads 14-0 here in the second quarter. Pass out completed to Mraz for the first down from Carter. And the rugby maul piling up at the 39-yard line of the Royals. And that is a first down for Righetti as they move across the 50.
And, again, they're going tempo here. This isn't their offense. They're trying to keep things moving.
And hand off to Langley. Langley going sideways, trying to gain some yardage, and he's pushed hard out of bounds by the Royals. And making that stop is Ethan Orozco.
And Ethan Orozco just finishing the tackle, getting all the way to the end. They talk about it in hockey more than they talk about it in football, because football, yeah, you finish the tackle when the whistle's done. You want to finish things all the way through. Finish the checks. That's what he did. He took it to the sideline and made sure until that whistle blew, he kept his legs moving.
Cash Carter in the shotgun. Hands off again to Mondal this time. Mondal coming in. Excuse me. Sunderhouse in on the play.
Champ Morrissey with the tackle for the Royals. He's one of those rangy linebackers. Connor Lopez gets a lot of attention, and rightfully so. Champ Morrissey's another one of those guys that's been making a lot of things happen for this Royals defense. Talk about it enough. Can't talk about it enough how much the defense is a team unit. That's a good example there.
And a shoulder tackle by Champ Morrissey on Sunderhouse. Brings up a fourth down and medium for the Warriors here.
A little bit of a Superman tackle, flying over the line, grabs the running back by the shoulders and brings him to the ground just kind of awkwardly back behind the line. That's a good linebacker play at this level. Next level may not be able to finish that tackle. Not going to finish that every week even at the high school level, but a good effort by Champ Morrissey to make it happen here.
Throws out to the flat to Langley. Langley turns the corner, quickly gobbled up by Lopez and Noziel. And that is going to be a turnover on downs. The second one given up by Righetti this game.
Well, Royals are going to get this ball. The question is going to be how fast they're going to try and move with it. Minute 29 left. Couple runs would just about do her, so they can get back to the locker room if they want on this drive very easily. But you know, get another score, you get the ball back in the second half, that's how you can put a game to sleep. So it's a question now for the Royals how eager they are to get this game finished versus how quick they want to get back to the locker room for halftime.
We'll see a lot of clock management here. Shotgun snap for Thomas Glenn. He fires quickly. Connor Lopez with the reception. Tackled at the 40-yard line.
It's tackled in bounds, but that should move the... It's first. It's second and negative one. The clock should be stopped as they move the ball forward. They're past the first down marker.
Clock still running. And that's a Mountain Air first down for the Mission Prep Royals. And movement at the line, a lot of confusion in that delay. 58 seconds remain in the half.
Looked like right tackle Armin Creighton moving, but he was initially started by Jordan Asako, who is in the middle of the neutral zone. That's why in high school they usually will call that when the defense jumps first, but I think they're going to say Asako was originally prompted by Armin Creighton. So I didn't see exactly who moved first, but my take was is the opposite. But either way, Royals moving back five.
Mission Prep with one timeout left. Righetti with all three here in this half. Three-man front for the defense. Glenn throwing this one deep. Luke Terry lost sight of it, trying to chase it down. And on that coverage is Thomas Harris for Righetti. And I think both the receiver and the corner lost track of that ball in the air.
A little bit. The lights of Spanos can play tricks on you sometimes. But I got to say, you look at Thomas Glenn's arm. It's really getting stronger as the season goes on. Those deep balls that we saw so often with Colby White to J.J. Howard last year and, you know, before that even with Tyler Garrett, those types of throws I think we're going to start seeing more again with Mission Prep as Thomas Glenn matures and gets his more confident with his arm.
Second and 15, the pitch out to the back. That is going to be Jaden Noziel, and laundry flying everywhere as Noziel makes it out to the 39-yard line. As it stops the clock to await the call, 44 seconds in the half.
Going to be a hold against Mission Prep. If I had to make a guess, it'd be Luke Terry, the wide receiver on the right side, who held up the corner coming in towards that tackle. So, you know, wide receiver this time going to be in trouble. But it's going to keep it at second down with 44 seconds left. The downs don't really matter right now as a result. So Mission Prep can either take a shot here or just run the clock out. A lot of options here for the Royals.
One timeout for David Schuster and his offense. The ball spotted back at the 25. It is going to be second and 25 for the Mission Prep Royals. And the handoff up the middle. Drew Harrigan with the carry. And we have a Warriors timeout for the first time in this half. And we're going to go ahead and take the timeout with them. Mission Prep football continues on PSNtv. Presented by California Fresh Market and driven by Hyundai San Luis Obispo.
The team at CB Chevrolet would like to welcome you to the dealership in San Luis Obispo, where we're confident you'll find the vehicles you're looking for at a price you can afford. Come and check out our full selection of new Chevrolet vehicles or get a great deal on a reliable pre-owned model. No matter which vehicle you decide on, our professional finance team will help you get settled with a competitive financing or lease plan at CB Chevrolet in San Luis Obispo.
Seconds remain on the clock, Steven. That is a lucky number for me. Hopefully it's a lucky number for the Royals right now as they are facing a 3rd and 19.
Yeah, Coach Russ Pickett, first-year head coach for Righetti, looking to get the ball back here with any amount of time left. When you're in high school, punts can do weird things. So even if they just force a punt here for Mission Prep, it could make a good situation for the Warriors.
And on his feet, Thomas Glenn making a dive on third down. Bringing up a fourth and 13. And you say that punts can do weird things in the game. That is absolutely true, as we saw an 81-yard punt return here in the second quarter by Jaden Noziel for a touchdown to make this a 14-0 game.
Oh, and, you know, it's Michigan State week. You don't got to remember about, we has trouble with the snap. I mean, it's every level of football. Long snapping's hard. Catching punts is hard. It's a wildly, you know, chaotic play of the punt. So just forcing a punt here could mean good news for the Warriors. But if something weird happens on their end, they could end up regretting it. So they've got to make the most out of this play. It's one that they burned two timeouts to make happen. So they'll probably get the ball back with about 20 seconds left, good enough to run two, three plays if they're smart with the clock with one timeout.
Quick update, St. Joseph leads Lompoc 26-0, 4:46 left in the second. And the punt high into the sky here at Alex G. Spano Stadium. And brought to the turf by Xavier Wiseman.
So the Warriors will take over here. They're going to try and make something happen in a big way. I expect to see Cash Carter be the quarterback on this drive. He's their more passing-focused quarterback. They split time between him and Gilbert Mariga. And Cash Carter, a little bit more careful with the football. Only has one interception, six touchdowns. As far as the year, you know, he's 47 for 111, 728 as far as his yardage goes. So, decently solid quarterback for the Warriors.
First and 10 for Righetti. The pass Incomplete and batted into the air by Mraz. If Arroyo would have had their head on a swivel and been within range, that could have been an interception quickly.
Well, I think Luke Terry was in the area. He was just shoved out of the way. Once that ball is batted, the PI is not a thing anymore. You can do, you know, be as violent as you want to be. And so that's what the Warriors did to full effect. Make sure that there's not going to be any weirdness as far as, you know, batted ball that falls into the wrong hands.
Well, if you can be as violent as you want, I want to see an elbow drop and a suplex.
Look, just be out there while the ball is batted. If you can think fast enough, I think they'll look the other way.
And we have whistles coming in from the sideline. Timeout, mission prep. And we're going to take mission prep in this timeout. Our score, 14-0 from Alex G. Spano Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field. Mission Prep Football continues on PSNtv. Nothing is our score. And they're trying to get this defense lined up. They're yelling. And the pass fired over the middle to Mraz. And Mraz can't get there in time. And I believe there's 11 seconds on the clock.
Just trying to use that quick slant route. It's great at beating deep man coverage, and it's something that Stanford used a great effect in their comeback against Colorado last week. So no surprise to see it used there a little bit. It's a great route.
Looks like there's 11 seconds on the clock. I've never seen the clock look like that here at Alex G. Spanos, just two digits. Langley in motion, throws to Langley in the flat. As they count down the end of the half and quickly tackled at the 40-yard line is Langley, and making that stop is freshman Miles Thompson.
Just a cattle catcher by Miles Thompson, bringing him down. It's tough to be a freshman on varsity, but Miles Thompson showing why he belongs. A physical, hardworking player. He's got a lot of speed to him, too. Good to see him get a tackle there.
3 seconds on the clock. I'm not used to the clock looking like this, Steven. I'm used to the decimal with the tenth of a second counting off.
I mean, look, why do you need more digits than you need? It's a three. It's a beautiful number.
I'm used to the colon being there.
Holy Trinity, all of that good stuff. Three is a good thing to be.
Now the question is, when you throw up three, do you hold it with your index finger down or your pinky finger down?
I do it with the index finger. It looks cooler.
Nah. Thomas says he does it with his pinky finger down. I do it two to one out of the three of us. You lose, Steven.
This is why democracy is a failed thing.
Pass completed to Mraz. Mraz across the 50 to the 45. Meets up with Luke Terry, who rustles him out of bounds. With a little assistance from Gabe Abada. And that's the end of the first half, Steven.
Yeah, smart little gamesmanship there. You know, you punt it away, you give the Royals a chance for a return. Run a simple screen play. You have a chance to score and not a high risk the other way. So just making one last shot of it for the Warriors.
And at halftime, our score 14-0 here from Alex G. Spanos Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field on the campus of Cal Poly, San Luis Obispo. And let's do a quick recap of our score before we take a break. To kick off the open of the second quarter, 11:55. A 13-yard touchdown run by Jaden Ozeal makes it 7-0, following the extra point by Cash Trevisan. And then with 9:58, following the possession to the Warriors, Ozeal following the possession to the Warriors after the touchdown. Let me rephrase that. Ozeal takes the punt, return 81 yards for the score. Our score 14-0 following the second extra point provided by Cash Trevisan. And at the break, 14-0, Mission Prep. And the cheerleaders are on the field. They will put on a little number for you. And I know our fans watching in town, across the state, and around the world love to support the cheerleaders at Mission College Prep. So we're going to go ahead and stick live with the cheerleaders before we run a couple commercial breaks. Appreciate you being with us at half. Again, our score, Mission Prep Royals 14, Righetti Warriors 0.
California Fresh Market is more than just your local grocery store. A full-service deli featuring premium boar's head meats and cheeses, handmade take-and-bake pizza, fresh salad and olive bar, gourmet cheese department perfect for any occasion, sushi rolled daily, organic and locally sourced produce, wild-caught seafood, choice prime and Snake River Farms American Wagyu beef, artisan sourdough bread, and full-service health and wellness. California Fresh Markets, the best on the Central Coast.
Family is ingrained in the core values of Mission Prep. So when picking cars, why not stay with family? And that means Hyundai San Luis Obispo. Yup, Hyundai Slo, located right on Auto Park Way off of Los Osos Valley Road, keeps it in the family with the Mission Prep familiarity involved. So go check out Hyundai Slo today for quality vehicles, a friendly team, and professional service at every step of the way. And tell them the Royals sent you.
As the road you travel changes, so can your insurance needs. Talking with Farmers Insurance agent Jennifer White can help you assess whether you're ready for the journey ahead. Call Farmers agent Jennifer White today at 805-592-1272. That's Jennifer White at 805-592-1272.
Underwritten by Farmers, Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
We are Farmers. Bum, ba, da, bum, 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 bum.
Located off Highway 101, just minutes from downtown San Luis Obispo, Pismo Beach, and Central Coast Wine Country, book your next Central Coast stay at Madonna Inn. With 110 unique guest rooms, on-site restaurants, bars, bakery, shopping, hiking, biking, and day spa, Madonna Inn is your travel destination dream. Let's go Mission Prep. Let's stay at Madonna Inn. We take this Mission Prep break to tell you about our friends at Gino's Pizza on Monterey Street in San Luis Obispo. They're open daily, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Give them a call if you're hungry right now, 805-752-1333. Now, why is Gino's unique? Well, they're a classic neighborhood family pizzeria known for distinctive pizza crusts, farm-fresh products, premium quality ingredients, and friendly service. At Gino's Pizza, they believe that pizza is one of, if not the only, heartwarming, mood-soothing, create-a-party ambiance anywhere, anytime comfort foods. Get down to Gino's Pizza on Monterey Street in downtown San Luis Obispo and tell them the Royals sent you. At KD Capital Mortgage, we know that your home is much more than four walls and a roof. Your home is where dreams are born and memories are made. That's why whether you're looking to refinance your current home, purchasing your dream home, or buying an investment property, our goal is to help you take advantage of today's historically low rates and make sure you find the right loan to match your specific needs. So whatever your mortgage needs may be, the perfect loan is waiting for you, and KD Capital is here to help. Please give us a call at 805-226-5550. A proud partner of the Mission Prep Royals.
Welcome back to Mission Prep Football. It is halftime here at Alex G. Spanos Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field. On the campus of Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, I am Brian Stanley. Our score at the break, 14-0, all on the back of Jaden Noziel. Jaden Noziel with a 13-yard touchdown run to open the second quarter, making it a 7-0 game. And then on Mission Prep's next possession, taking it to the barn on an 81-yard touchdown return, punt return to the touchdown, that is, making it 14-0. On the extra points of Cash Trevisan. We've seen the passing game come to life, Steven. We've seen the run game come to life. We've seen the Righetti Warriors struggle in this ball game. What is it going to take for the Mission Prep Royals to walk away with the W and to close this one out?
Well, they got to find some consistency on offense. They've had some issues here and there. You know, when you're trying to limit possessions, you've really got to have excellence each possession. That's what the Mustangs learned during the triple option years on this very field. Well, not this one. It was grass back then. If you're not consistently converting and moving that ball, things can spiral out of hand really quickly. So it's still a two-score game. This is a game that the Warriors have gotten good push from time to time. The Royals have gotten good push from time to time. All it takes is a couple breaks the wrong way, and suddenly it's going to be a tie game for the Royals. You know, they're leading by 14, but that doesn't mean it's going to stay that way. This is a Warriors team that knows how to fight back. And there's a reason why all of their scores are remarkably close. It's because they don't quit. And I expect Coach Russ Pickett is in the locker room at halftime. Just remember everyone, hey, it's a 14-point game. This is by far not out of hand. And they've had a few moments where the Warriors have been knocking towards the end zone. They had that long drive that had two fourth downs. And they weren't able to convert on the second one. They had the last drive there. But they're moving the ball well, and it just didn't come together for them. So right now, the Warriors are still in this. They've still got a good chance to keep things moving. It's a matter of, can the Royals make good on their possessions? Do the things that they know how to do best? Keep that power run going? Or is it going to be an issue that, you know, that inconsistency leads to the really leaning on the defense? Defense is the best part of this team, but you don't want to have to lean on it the whole time. It's going to be up to the Royals to find consistency on offense. They really want to take this one home.
And as we are here at the break, one thing I noticed, see, they have the punt team, or the kicking unit out here warming up, or the kicker, that is, Johnny Castillo. And he is currently booting it from 37 yards out through the uprights, getting his leg warmed up for the second half, because he could become a crucial factor in this game down the stretch. But there's something else I wanted to talk about tonight, Stephen, before we get to the end of this game, because right now it is going in favor of the Royals, which means potentially we could have a new top-tier coach at Mission College Prep.
And I mean, he's been a top-tier coach.
I was going to clarify what I meant there. And when I mean top-tier, I don't mean just mean the cream of the crop. I mean he is the milestone marker that all must meet after tonight, if that happens. And that is Coach David Schuster, currently tied with 51 wins with former head coach Chad Henry. And Chad Henry coached at Michigan College Prep from 2010 to 2016, seven seasons, sporting a record of 51-27.
Are you aware of what do you know what a announcer's jinx is? Some people have been saying that recently. I don't know what it means. Do you?
I don't, because going to continue to talk about this.
Okay.
And head coach David Schuster comes in tonight with a record of 51-17, a perfect 75%. When I say perfect 75%, because there is no change after the decimal, it is a perfect 75%.
Yeah, exactly. Three quarters of the games have gone his way. And it's been a real pleasure being there for a lot of that journey. Obviously, not all of it, but you look at how Coach Schuster coaches and what he gets out of the players that enter this program. It's much more than just becoming good football players. They're guys that will really drive themselves and find ways to succeed both on and off the field. Talking to the coaches that have gone on to coach Mission Prep Royals, including Coach Wolf at Cal Poly, he talks about how much the guys that have come through this program are just real players, real quality guys that are focused, come to practice, do the things that are asked of them. And if you're wondering where Colby White's at right now, he's playing at Cal Poly. He was a quarterback in high school. He's getting time on the kickoff cover. You don't normally ask your quarterbacks to get time on special teams, but that's where Colby White's finding time, and he's not complaining. He's loving it. Coach Wolf has spoken very highly of him, and that's the type of player that, you know, it comes out of Mission Prep. It's the guy that's going to do the work. It's going to be the person that doesn't leave the details for later. It's going to be the guy that really wants to be the best version of himself. And that's why Coach Schuster has been so successful. As much of a great guy as he is, it's the players. The proof is in the pudding. The people that come play here, you always hear about attracting right bait to attract the right prey. Well, the right things are showing up for Coach Schuster, He's got the right players coming in, year out. He's helping mold them into even better men going forward. And to me, that's what high school football is all about. It's not just about winning games. The records disappear at the end of the season. It's a castle built out of sand. You know, it's not something worth focusing on. That win-loss record wouldn't mean a lot if the men that came out of this program weren't finding other ways to succeed in life. Because if you're still talking about high school football much after college, you got to find new hobbies. You know, you can discuss it while you're talking about football with your buddies and comparing where you came from. But, you know, I could not tell you my high school records back when I was at Slo High. I know they weren't as good as some of the other local teams, but that's about as far as it goes. I can tell you some of the memorable moments, the people I met. But the lessons that I learned playing high school football, those have been carried with me for the rest of my life.
Well, today, not only did I go to the team luncheon, but I went to the team devotion. And Father Russ Brown was talking about the first two things that Mission Prep strives for any young man that comes through the program is to be a scholar and a gentleman. That's their first two goals. And anything above that is bonus. So if you could become a great athlete in the process, that's a bonus. And so you talk about the men that come from this program. It's not just the program. I think it's the overall environment that which they're in, the scholar, the gentleman, and then the athlete that comes along with that.
Well, you talk about, you know, devotion. Let's talk about the devotion for the year. Colossians 1:10. They, you know, have it down to the two words, the walk worthy. The full verse is to walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing to him, beaming in fruit in every good work, and increasing the knowledge of God. That book of Colossians, is a letter from the Apostle Paul to the city of Colos. It is co-authored by Timothy and sent out. Paul was in prison during this time. He was trying to establish the church that would go on to become the Roman Catholic Church from behind prison bars on his way to be beheaded in Rome. So you talk about, you know, what it means to establish that, become a good man. That's what Walk Worthy is all about. That's what this entire program is all about. And that's why I really like the Walk Worthy as the kind of team devotional for the year. It's sending that message of this isn't for long. You got to do what you want to do now and walk worthy in a sense that it will last past you. You know, that's what the Apostle Paul was doing from behind bars on his way to Rome, where he would be killed in the Circus of Nero, if I remember correctly, alongside Paul, Simon Peter, who is the first pope of the Catholic Church. Peter was crucified upside down, as long as we're getting the grisly details of it. But, you know, the fact that he was still writing these stories, writing these letters, telling people how the correct way to worship was, it's a great devotional for the way that Coach Schuster runs his program and the way that it's not just about those wins and losses on the field. It's about how they walk afterwards, what they carry away from this program, because those wins do not follow you to the college ranks.
Yes, those wins do not follow you to the college ranks, and that is the motto, to walk worthy. And we got 24 minutes of football to decide a winner here in this Mountain League contest. One of these two teams will break the loss streak. Royals with only one loss, and the Righetti Warriors coming in with a six-game streak of losing, trying to get their first league win. So we're just going to get this one going here in the third quarter. I'm Brian Stanley. Joining me, Stephen Hodges, our cameraman tonight. Back in action, Thomas Bowden, the man, the myth, the legend, the cameraman of all cameramen in the house tonight. And here's the kickoff to Mission Prep into the hands of Luke Terry. And Terry gets tied up at the 32-yard line. And making the big shoulder tackle, Alex Nerez.
Vance Abercrombie also getting in all that flying tackle as Nerez held him up. The Royals going to be taking the ball back over. We talked about it. It's that consistent play that you want to see from the offense right now. They've got to make sure that they're making the most of this drive. They want to have those long, hold-on-to-the-ball types of drives. It doesn't necessarily need the points right now, but right now they just need to have that consistency of getting the chains moving and moving down the field. It's been a little sputtering to start the game out here, but the second half has been better for the Royals throughout this season.
Glenn hands it off to the back. Bulldozes forward. The locomotive colliding with a warrior. And that warrior on the turf. Here comes the safety unit to help him off the turf. Talking about getting hit by a locomotive.
Looks like Josiah Coronado on the ground for the Warriors. That is a big hit by Drew Harrigan. They might take an extra second here. We might need to step aside once again.
And we will step aside because he is on the turf getting looked over, and the Royals go to the sideline. We'll be right back. Mission Prep Football continues on PSN TV.
Hi, this is John Deere with Deere Automotive.
Someday,
and that's my son Tom singing. You can feel a glow when it comes to the way your car looks when you bring it to Deere Auto Body.
I will feel a glow with just thinking of you.
From minor dings to major collision repair, we can give your car a like-new showroom look. We can straighten and repair any frame type using ultrasound technology. Our refinish department features paints that exceed factory specifications, and they are applied in our state-of-the-art, environmentally friendly spray booth. Plus, we work hand-in-hand with your insurance company so your claim goes smoothly. Love the way your car looks. Bring it to Via Auto Body and Collision Repair, and let our family take care of your family. Nicely done, son.
We take this mission prep break to tell you about our friends at Gino's Pizza on Monterey Street in San Luis Obispo. They're open daily, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Give them a call if you're hungry right now, 805-752-1333. Now, why is Gino's unique? Well, they're a classic neighborhood family pizzeria known for distinctive pizza crusts, farm fresh products, premium quality ingredients, and friendly service. At Gino's Pizza, they believe that pizza is one of, if not the only, heartwarming, mood-soothing, create-a-party ambiance anywhere, anytime comfort foods. Get down to Gino's Pizza on Monterey Street in downtown San Luis Obispo and tell them the Royals sent you.
It's time for an MPG upgrade at Sunset Honda.
Save big with Sunny's end-of-summer deals at Sunset Honda. Like 3.29% financing for 60 months on select pre-owned Hondas. Or take advantage of $1,250 in Honda loyalty on every new Ridgeline and get 2 years of free scheduled maintenance with any new 23 Honda.
Plus, get a $25 gas card just for taking a test drive.
Trade in your gas guzzler today and get $1,000 over Kelley Blue Book from the start.
Get started today at sunsethonda.com.
And Adrian Mondal up off the turf, walking off the field under his own power, which is tremendous news to see any player that's been looked over on the ground get up and walk away. We're now face down with a 2nd and 7 for the Mission Prep Royals. Back under action here in the third quarter, 11:26 on the clock. The snap, the handoff, and Harrigan got the wheels turning on the locomotive and delivers another big hit as the running back, and this time delivering the hit to Malachi Langley, and that is a Mountain Air first down for the Mission Prep Royals.
Drew Harrigan with a head full of steam once again, moving the chains well. We talk about the power this guy has and how he's able to get out to the open field. That's all it takes. You know, if he's getting the blocks ahead of him, they're going to keep the chains moving. He is a tough guy to take down once he's into the secondary. So the O-line doing a good job giving him the room to get upfield, just moving the chains forward.
Under center. Takes a snap, hands off to Drew Harrigan. Quickly met in the backfield was Harrigan, and making the stop is Twisselman, Daryl Twisselman, and a loss of one for the Royals. 2nd and 11, ball spotted at the 48, between the 47 and 48 yard line. We'll say at the 48.
lightening up the backfield right now are the Royals. Looks like they're going to go to a more wide-open set. This can work in two different ways. They could be looking to pass the ball or start to use the perimeter a little bit more, or they could just be trying to unload the box. Right now the Warriors have about eight players in the box on any given play. If they change out, get some wide receivers, they'll be forced to cover them, take those players out of the box.
Second and 11. Handoff right up the middle. Drew Harrigan off to the races. Nobody in front of him. 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, Royals! And that is a 52-yard touchdown run for Drew Harrigan. Back in action. Finding the end zone for the Royals. For the seventh time this season, his 35th touchdown of his career.
Drew Harrigan running right between the hash marks, right down the middle of the field. He made it look like the fast lane. Nothing slowing him down, and no way the Warriors were going to touch him once he got past that group of linebackers. Just too much speed, too much power. A beautiful run by Drew Harrigan.
Castrovizin gets the kick up and good. And that is 21 unanswered points put up by the Mission Prep Royals here at Mustang Memorial Field. We're in the third quarter. The Royals lead 21-0 over the Righetti Warriors. We'll be right back.
Get a head start on your New Year's goals with Kennedy Club Fitness. Locations all over San Luis Obispo County. You've got classes, sauna, steam room, tub, and a heated pool. It's where I work out. It's Kennedy Club Fitness.
Steven, it has been 12 minutes and 6 seconds since the last touchdown was scored.
That feels like it's only been a few seconds as Drew Harrigan just finished that one into the end zone. But
oh, that,
you know,
I'm
I'll
talking
say,
about
yeah.
since his. That was the span between Nozil's 81-yard punt return and Harrigan's 52-yard touchdown run.
Hey, you know, I've been losing some sleep. I figured take a quick nap. Oh, it's been 12 minutes. Ready for another kickoff. But right now, Warriors are going to get the ball for the first time in the second half. They're going to try and set up something on this drive. They need to find the end zone. They need to find a way to get the points. They've been getting down to the red zone. They just haven't been finishing the drive with points. So that's going to be the challenge here for the Warriors. Is it fair caught on a short kick? The Warriors really need to find a way to get the points going because it looks like that run game for the Royals is taking off. Just like we talked out at halftime, when that run game gets going for the Royals, there's not a team on the Central Coast that's going to slow it down. So it's now up to the Warriors to keep pace, keep this ball moving. They had some good tempo in the first half. If they get back to that tempo game, I like their chances. But tempo only works when you're getting positive plays.
First and 10 from the 28-yard line. The Righetti Warriors with the ball. Two receivers to his left, one to his right. Langley goes in motion, takes the handoff on the snap, finds some room, reverses direction before he meets up with his lineman. And Langley with a good carry. That might be enough to move the sticks. Gabe Amada with the tackle for Mission Prep. And that's going to be a second and inches.
Now Langley showing the danger of cutting back into the formation. Warriors, or the Royals rather, were waiting there for him, and that's a big hit by Almada.
And big hit delivered by Champ Morrissey. Jeepers! And he lights up Ethan Sonderhaus for a loss. And that's a short loss, but that was a big hit. And the Royals are getting live here tonight.
As a run between the guards, you're not supposed to lose yardage on that sort of play. That's supposed to be a very easy. You're going to get maybe a few yards. Maybe you get stopped at the line of scrimmage. But Champ Morrissey fired in the backfield when delivered a huge hit.
Hand off to Langley. Langley trying to get the first down and does just that. And that moves the sticks for Righetti here in the third quarter. Our score, 21-0. Mission Prep leads in this Mountain League action presented by California Fresh Market and driven by Hyundai San Luis Obispo. It's a beautiful night here in San Luis Obispo, by the way, Stephen.
Almost always is. Is Champ Morrissey involved in another tackle there? He's all over the field tonight.
And a delayed throw by Cash Carter out to the right side, completed to Jacob Nelson. Nelson with three touchdown receptions this season. Trying to get across the 50 because that would give him another first down, the Righetti Warriors.
Not sure if that's supposed to be an RPO or a delayed play action. Is a strange screenplay. Either way, still delivered a good ball, and sometimes that's all it takes is just get the ball to the playmaker, and that's what happened there.
Second and four for Righetti here in the third quarter. In motion is Finley, and the handoff to the back and getting pulled down from behind is Sanderhaas. I'm making up names here, Stephen.
Sanderhaas pushing forward into Mustang Mission territory as the Warriors, again, keeping that good tempo. They're getting the positive plays. Mission hasn't given them anything to really, you know, slow down about. So they're going to try and keep this gas pedal down.
Carter looking to throw this one. Decides to keep it himself. And that doesn't fare too well for Carter as he gains about a half yard before he's tripped up at the line of scrimmage by Game Amata.
Amata and Ethan Ferrales up front. Ferrales doing a good job just winning his battle and then catching him at the end. Fell on the running back towards the very end of the play, but that's the type of play that helps out a defense. You're getting a zero or negative yard play. Well, that's going to force the offense to slow down. You get a chance to catch your breath and really scheme for the next set.
Delayed handoff, keeps it himself. Pass thrown out to the left side. They're going to say he caught that one. Jacob Nelson pulling it in as he hits the turf. And that's going to be a 9-yard reception for Nelson out to the 39-yard line of the Royals.
Luke Terry with a good tackle there. Of course, our homecoming king here on the homecoming evening for the Royals. So good to see him getting involved in the game. He's been a little bit quiet as it's been a few pass targets and a couple tackles, but that's been about it.
Carter throwing this one out complete. No, spoke too soon as it slips through the hands of Mraz out the back door.
No.
Incomplete pass.
In these passing situations, keep an eye on the one and two. That's Jacob Nelson and Damian Mraz, the two leading receivers for the Warriors. They have 47 receptions between them coming into this game. They've had a couple more here tonight, and they've evenly split the touchdowns, three apiece. As it's actually be Nelson heading off. So Mraz on the bottom side of your screen. If they're looking to throw, that's where they're going to be going.
Handing it off to Langley, and Langley met up with, oh my gosh, Luke Terry. All these names tonight are getting to me, Steven. I think I'm getting old.
Just a little too far. Pushing the chance forward are the Warriors. Langley's been doing a good job. He's got a high compete level. You know, it's something that they're keeping an eye on as he's got such a loud mouth. We're hearing what he's saying on the sideline all the way up here in the booth. But that's what you need in these types of games, that fire to keep yourself going as the Warriors driving right now.
Warriors have double stack receivers on the right side. Carter throws out complete to Nelson. Nelson gets enough for the first down. And the Warriors moving the sticks again on this drive. A drive that started back mid-Warriors territory, now into mid-Royals territory.
Now, almost to the red zone. The Warriors have been down there before. We've seen that the kicker is capable of doing, you know, some big things with his leg. So this is where you start looking. They need to get points here. They need to push the ball a little bit further, get into field goal range, and look for that touchdown.
Carter, pass complete to Finley over the middle. And that is back-to-back plays with back-to-back first downs for Righetti here. 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter. 21-0 Mission Prep, both teams with all three timeouts.
Cash Carter's just in rhythm right now. He's hard to knock out of it. He's looking for the end zone.
Langley right up the middle going down the left hash marks. And Langley pushes in past the five down to the 3 yard line. And I would say that the Warriors are sniffing that pay dirt. They want a little bit of that action of the in the end zone.
Well, they need it right now. We're under 5 minutes in the third. They need to get into the end zone if they want to have a chance here in the fourth quarter. It's a 21-point lead. You need to eat into that to have a chance here in the fourth quarter with how well Mission holds on to the ball.
Langley in motion. Hand off to the fullback. And the fullback gets stuffed. Vance Abercrombie, who normally plays middle linebacker.
Oh, this is where, when you get this close to the goal line, it's where you stop asking the question of, well, who's the best, who's the fastest, all that. It's who can hold on to the ball and who's tough. Doesn't matter who's got the best, you know, counter step, most deceptive. You're just trying to push strength against strength.
Abercrombie again dives in for the touchdown. A 1 yard score. And the Righetti Warriors on the board for the first time tonight with 3:35 on the clock.
Might be his first offensive touchdown of the year, but definitely not his first touchdown of the year. Vance Abercrombie has a nose for the end zone. And as we said, strength versus strength, they went to the big guy, the big, strong linebacker for the Warriors. Not normally part of the offense, but finishes it there as we've got a fire drill for the PAT squad. This is going to be no good as it'll go into the books as a run attempt, but just diving on that was the holder, Gilbert Mariga.
And after that failed PAT, it is 21-6 here at Alex G. Spano Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field. And we'll be right back. Royals football continues on PSN TV.
Get a head start on your New Year's goals with Kennedy Club Fitness. Locations all over San Luis Obispo County. You've got classes, sauna, steam room, tub, and a heated pool. It's where I work out. It's Kennedy Club Fitness.
A 1 yard Abercrombie run gets the Righetti Warriors on the board. And that is Vance Abercrombie, the junior middle linebacker, carrying the ball with the dive play over the line. The goal line, that is. Our score, 21-6, following a missed or a failed extra point attempt as they had a fault on the ball to prevent any kind of more mistakes. Here's the kickoff deep into the territory of Luke Terry, and Terry collects it at the 16-yard line, cuts back across field, and is brought down by Vance Abercrombie back on the defensive side of the ball.
Well, he's really one block away from springing that, and as on the non-play side, he's trying to get all the way back to the far side of action where all the blocks are being set up. He had three people right in front of him, couldn't go straight ahead, tried to bend it back to where the Royals were, and was one block away from being able to do so. And we've seen how dangerous special teams have been in this game, so there was trouble brewing for the Royals right there as they had a good chance for a strong return. Ends up being right around their own 20, pretty standard field position for them.
Single receiver in the line for Mission Prep. Chase Untall in motion and pulled down in the backfield, met by Gabriel Sanchez. Sanchez been known to break through the line. 3 sacks this season, Steven.
And he's a guy that can get back there and disrupt things. Right now, the Warriors just doing a good job with the contain. Nothing going there for the Royals. That contain is vital if you're going to try any sort of pitch out. You're really risking a major negative play if you're going to run out to the side and the ends have that sort of penetration on the outside.
Warriors are showing blitz, and they hand it off to the back. And a short gain as the Warriors brought almost everybody on that one. And Drew Harrigan on the carry.
Just a good old-fashioned run blitz by the defense. Fill every gap right at the point of attack. Don't give anything for the run team to work with. When the offense can't have a gap to run through, they can't run the ball. It's as easy as that. So The Royals have to clear that out. They've got to find a way to get a little bit more motion. But we saw what happened with that motion last time. It was a nice little pitch out that was swallowed up by the defense again. So a tough drive here for the Royals if they can't convert here on third down.
Nozeal in motion. They fake the pitch out to Nozeal, and it goes to Untal. And Chase Untal gets out to past the 20 to the 23-yard line. That brings up fourth down and about seven for Mission Prep.
Big time stop for the Warriors there. They're going to get the ball back and should have pretty good field position here. They got a little bit more jive in the step there for the Royals. Tried the fake to, you know, fake the pitch, inside handoff type deal. Warriors just stayed on their assignments and were able to shut it down. So they're going to have a chance to get the ball back and build some momentum, maybe make this a one-score game.
Pressure getting into the punter, Thomas Glenn, and that pressure coming by Jacob Nelson. And the Warriors will start with it in their own territory at the 43-yard line. 1:10 remaining in the third quarter. Don't forget, we still got to pick our player of the game. We got a couple candidates to pick from right now, including Jaden Nozeal and Drew Harrigan. If you think somebody should be in the mix, drop their name in the chat, and we'll give it a consideration. First and 10 for Righetti. Ball on the 43-yard line. A five-man defensive front for Mission Prep as the flags come out here. 1:08 in the third quarter.
They're going to say this is too much motion up front by the Warriors. And to marsh them on back. Last time the Warriors were out, they had that touchdown. You look, yeah, there's a lot of time left on the clock. But with both teams being as reliant on the run as they've been, you know, you start doing the math, the Warriors might only have two or three more drives after this one. So if you're not converting on each one when you get the ball, you're leaving a big window open for the Royals to just score once and have it be the end. So each possession more and more critical for these Righetti Warriors.
And Cash Carter in the shotgun. Time running thin here for Righetti. And this back judge has spaced out his time, giving him, and here comes the hand, 5 seconds up. And Cash Carter looking to throw this one, chased down by the Royals, and the pass completed out to the far side to Langley. Malachi Langley pulling it in, getting Righetti across the 50 and a new set of downs.
And Malachi Langley is not the biggest wide receiver or running back on the roster for the Warriors, but he's getting so much play time because of that compete level. Every time he's out there, he's playing like it's the, you know, it's fourth down in a championship game. He's got a lot of heart, got a lot of energy out there. That's what gets you playing time, is that effort level. And Malachi Langley shows it on every play.
Three-man front for Mission Prep. Throw out to the near side. Nelson with the completion from Carter. And Righetti moving the ball well through the air in the second half. 26 seconds on the clock as the clock has stopped.
And Warriors have been fortunate today. That's the second fumble that's happened for the Warriors. Both fumbles have been out of bounds. First one was in the first quarter. This one happening just now is there's going to be an injured Warrior on the sideline. The sideline preventing us from being able to see in to see who it is. But they're going to take a second here.
Yeah, they're going to take a second to deal with the injury, as it is technically kind of in the plane of play. As of a player were to run out of bounds, it'd run right over him. And they want to make sure everybody is safe here, as the player on the ground is considered defenseless.
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's still technically in the field of play in that boundary area. That's the coach's box. You have to have that clear of any players that are not actively playing.
So we're going to take a quick timeout here. Mission Prep football on PSN TV is driven by Hyundai of San Luis Obispo.
It's and Jacob presented. Nelson, and he's up with some assistance. So.
Okay, we're going to stick with it. We're not going to take the time out. So.
It's as soon as you hit that button, they know. They're watching you, Brian.
I've every home game at Mission College Prep during basketball season, I ask for a TV timeout. And they say no.
Well, you got to keep asking. That's the worst they can tell you.
I'm still petitioning, though. This year, it's going to continue.
Got to ask.
Yeah, got to ask. Maybe one day they'll grant it to me. I'll get one. Cash Carter looking for a payday, but yet throws this one away.
That's intentional grounding. There's not a receiver in the area. I think it may have been 10 yards down the line of scrimmage, but there's no one there.
20 seconds in the third quarter. 15 points separate these two squads. Mission Prep looking to get back into the winning ways. Deep pass off target. Ozil looking to chase that one down and almost gets to it.
No miscommunication there. The route being run was a post. The route being thrown was a corner.
And the official, and then we have a timeout taken by Righetti as the coaches immediately come out barking at Cash Carter. So we'll take the timeout. We'll be right back. Mission Prep Football continues.
Family is ingrained in the core values of Mission Prep. So when picking cars, why not stay with family? And that means Hyundai San Luis Obispo. Yup, Hyundai Slow, located right on Auto Parkway off of Los Osos Valley Road, keeps it in the family with the Mission Prep familiarity involved. So go check out Hyundai Slow today for quality vehicles, a friendly team, and professional service at every step of the way. And tell them the Royals sent you.
If anybody in this booth has a caffeine addiction, it is me.
Huh? Maybe. I'd say almost certainly. Between the three of us.
I've had 4 energy drinks this afternoon. Cash Carter on 3rd down and 10 fires over the middle and almost picked off by the freshman Miles Thompson.
And good job. You know, you talk about looking around, being aware of where the route's going and where you are in the field. That's great field awareness by the freshman. Saw the post coming up behind him and looked where the ball was coming, and he had his hands right where they needed to be for the pick, just a little bit off base to make the catch. So that's what I expect in the future will go right in the hands of big number 6.
And going for it on 4th down, the Warriors ready to go for it. 4th and 10. Fired over the middle and throwing himself off his feet trying to catch it is Aiden Finley. That was a good attempt. Throwing himself in the air to try to catch that one. And a turnover on downs, the 3rd one of the night presented by the Righetti Warriors.
That's a rough situation for the Warriors. Just felt a little bit rushed as the Royals will get the ball to finish out the 3rd quarter here and more importantly, go into the 4th quarter with the ball. We talk, you know, grind. Well, if they are able to get a 1st down here, that's another couple minutes off the clock, another couple minutes. You know, the Warriors right now might be playing for more of a tie, just knowing how many more possessions they have. So it's a good go on 4th down there.
But I'll come back to something in a second. As Royals have 1st and 10, Glenn takes the snap, throws it out to the near side. That pass completed to his receiver, Vinny Orlando, and Orlando read the reception at the 48-yard line, moving the sticks. That is a Royals Mountain Air 1st down as we come to the end of the 3rd quarter. I have a thought, Steven. We're going to go to break. I'll share it when I get back. Mission Prep Football continues on PSNtv.
Welcoming you to Momentum Health Chiropractic. If you've got pain, get premium chiropractic care for only $47. It covers exams, x-rays, and one complete treatment. If you're experiencing a health concern and looking for an all-natural way to help resolve the underlying cause, we're here for you. Book your appointment and get started today, 805-541-6966, or scan the QR code on your screen now.
Steven, we're talking about scoring here. 21-6 is our score. The ball before the 1st down was back at the 28-yard line. at halftime, we saw the kicker, Johnny Castillo, boot it easily from the ball spotted at the 27-yard line, making it a 37-yard kick. That would have been a 38-yard kick if they would have gone for the 3 points, making it a 21-9 ball game.
That would have been a 45-yard kick.
No.
28 yards, okay. 7 yards
yes.
for the snap.
Yeah, I'm not doing my math correct. That's why I'm a broadcaster. And Drew Harrigan with the carry out across the 35, a flag in the backfield. I forgot to add the 7 yards. You are correct.
It's going to be a hold against the Royals. This is coming back, but, you know, can't take that run out of the memory of the Warriors right there. That's a good run by Drew Harrigan. And that's why I said it's a good go for it there because, you know, you're late in the game. You only know you're going to have so many more possessions. You go for it on fourth down in that situation. Give your team the best chance of a touchdown rather than a field goal. Even if you got a kicker that could make it from there, you know, it's a tough situation. You know, obviously, if you've got someone that's hitting about 90, sure. But when it's warm-up distance, you know, I always hear, oh, well, we saw a kicker hit a 60-yarder in warm-ups. It's like, yeah, when he's got no pressure and can watch the ball the whole way he's kicking it, has the full run-up. You know, kicking in formation is a much different ball game than kicking off a tee. And that's why sometimes you'll see college kickers, they'll kick, you know, 70-yarders during warm-ups and then choke away a 30-yarder.
And right up the middle with a nice seam, carrying the ball for Mission Prep, Carter Moreau.
Interesting to see Carter Moreau carrying the ball. I figured if they're going to switch out Drew Harrigan, it'd be going back to Miles Thompson. But Moreau running that ball. Looks like there's going to be holding again against the Royals. Back at the line of scrimmage. So it's going to be first and 30.
So we're going from the ball spotted at the previous play. The ball was spotted at the 38-yard line. We go back to the 33-yard line. It's going to be first and 25.
Quite the distance here to make up for the Royals, but I think they're going to be A-okay with it because the clock's still moving. You're getting down to 11 minutes, one full minute gone off, and they haven't even used up a down on this drive, the first drive of this second or fourth quarter.
Moreau with the carry. He gets out past the numbers, trying to turn the corner, and gains a couple yardage as he's pushed into the Royals bench. The home crowd not liking some action on that sideline.
You know, Royals not thrilled with that extra little push at the end, but Carter Moreau doing a fantastic job running the ball for the Royals. He's not typically the first name you're going to think of as far as the running backs go. That's going to be Drew Harrigan. There's been some other running backs coming through, Ronnie Kardashian, Miles Thompson, you know, Chase Untall. They've got a lot of different guys that they try and get the ball to throughout the season. But
Jayden
so far,
Ozeal.
Jayden Ozeal, you know, he's usually coming on as a you know, that wide receiver kind of fly action deal as he's got that touchdown today. But, you know, I got to say, Moreau doing great.
Right up the middle, Moreau. Moreau doing the tightrope walk through the defense. And Moreau taken down at the original line of scrimmage where this all started. Ball spotted at the 47-yard line of Mission Prep. And that is a tightrope walk by Moreau.
And Moreau going right through the guy, the defense, to get that yardage. That's not what Righetti wants to see.
Moreau again, just slipping through the line, pushing forward on third down, and he's across the 50 at the 49 of Righetti. Mission Prep still moving this ball.
What a lead fullback block can do for you. Fullback's been out of fashion for a long time. They're starting to make a real comeback, even though they're calling him, oh, it's a flanker back. Oh, no, actually, he's a tight end. He's a blocking tight end that lines up in the backfield. It's called a fullback. And this is what they can do. You get that momentum going forward out of the backfield. It'll push and penetrate and create holes in the defense that allow your running back to follow it through. It's a beautiful thing.
And rolling out, Glenn keeping it himself. He's got some room. Here, we had some room. But the stutter step, he's brought down. And the tackle by Damian Mraz. And Ethan Brown in on it as well. The first turnover on downs of the night by Mission College Prep.
And, you know, he trusted his legs enough to get out of the backfield and get going forward, but didn't trust them enough to carry him to the first down marker. That stutter step, he lost all of his momentum. You know, and he's a ways away from the first down marker still. I see the need of why he decided to try and make a defender miss rather than going straight forward, but I think he had enough speed to carry himself to the first down marker if he had just dove forward.
An update from our opponent next week. 3:11 in the third. St. Joseph 29, Lompoc nothing. That pass complete out to Mraz. And Mraz pulled down by the defense. And a name we've called multiple times tonight, Ethan Orozco. And I think it's safe to say that Ethan Orozco is in the running for our player of the game on defense tonight. He's definitely been a defensive performance.
Orozco and Champ Morrissey really have been the highlight defenders in my eyes so far tonight. There hasn't been a lot of turnover creation or tackles for loss, but you know, those guys have been involved heavily.
And Langley met at the line of scrimmage, able to get a couple yards out of it. And the big man at the line taking a hit on the shoulder, Ethan Ferrales, but picks himself off the turf and jogs off to the sideline as Gabe Rodriguez checks in. And the handoff to Langley once again. Malachi Langley pulled to the turf by Armin Clayton. And this defense coming up clutch, trying to slow down the Righetti Warriors here. 7:28 on the clock. We're running in the final quarter. Mission Prep leads by 15, 21-6.
Well, the Warriors have the tempo to keep this a game, even if they end up having to work against the clock towards the end here. So this is a important drive for the Warriors, as there's a little bit of confusion up front as to where the strength call was.
Hand off out of the backfield with a flag flying. And Sanderhaus carrying it.
This is going to move back on a holding call against the Warriors. You know, you start doing the math. It is very important through a football game as far as, you know, how much time you got left. Right now, the Warriors need to keep that tempo going. They don't have enough to, you know, really take their time into the end zone here, focus on that run game. I'd be using that tempo to the most of my advantage because you don't want to end up in an end-of-game situation where you're just hoping to get an onside kick. You know, onside kicks are great tools, but when you need them, they're almost impossible to get.
I stand corrected on the back carrying the ball. That was Abercrombie. And Abercrombie again with the carry and dragging the defender, Ethan Orozco, with him for 3 yards. Reminded me of the days of Bo Jackson dragging defenders with him.
Man, there's a little bit of an age difference there, but, I mean, I can't – when was the last time Bo Jackson played football? That was like, what, 95?
Yes, I pulled out Bo Jackson in a reference.
He wasn't even a power back. You know, you're not even going like, oh, it's like when Mike Allstott did it, you know?
It was the first
talk
back
about
that popped
fullbacks.
It was the first back that popped into my head. Bear with me here. Pass over the middle, incomplete. That hot cannon was intended for Alec Naraz.
I bet there's players on the roster whose parents weren't like.
I think I broke Steven.
I like Bo Jackson. Is the thing that I don't like about this is it's just such a. Let me tell you, back when Jim Brown was running this program, we really had something, you know.
I broke Steven. Oh my! Someone help me.
I'm talking about how John Heisman run this offense.
Fourth down, going for a pass complete to Damian Mraz. Mraz looking for the end zone. A couple men to beat, and guess who gets the tackle? Ethan Orozco. First down for Righetti.
Connor Lopez coming over the top to finish things off. Really saved the touchdown there. Orozco had a good grip, but I'm not sure it would have been enough to get that tackle. Warriors back into the red zone again. They've been there quite a bit this afternoon, and they're really looking to make sure that they finish here. They've had some issues with finishing. That's been the big complaint with the Warriors throughout this game. It's not that they don't have the talent. They don't have whatever it takes. They're just not executing in key opportunities. This is another key chance here where they can really make something special happen.
Langley spins off one defender and met by two. And Malachi Langley brought down at the 9-yard line. A big stop by the Royals. Royals trying to keep Righetti out of the end zone. Second down for Righetti, 21-6, as we approach 5 minutes to go in this Mountain League contest. The final home game of the regular season here at Mustang Memorial Field. And we have a timeout taken by Mission Prep. Their first timeout of the half. We'll be right back. Mission Prep football continues.
Welcoming you to Momentum Health Chiropractic. If you've got pain, get premium chiropractic care for only $47. It covers exams, x-rays, and one complete treatment. If you're experiencing a health concern and looking for an all-natural way to help resolve the underlying cause, we're here for you. Book your appointment and get started today, 805-541-6966, or scan the QR code on your screen now.
With a reference to the Techno Bowl legend, Bo Jackson, Steven's still confused by my references. I am old.
You're not that much older than me is what bothers me about it.
See, my references remind me of the references provided by Kevin Richardson when he was broadcasting with Justin Allegre. That just enough difference there that they didn't match up very well. So on pop culture references, that is. But when it comes to football, it's all the same. And here comes Righetti. Langley trying to go for it. And he's run out of bounds by Jaden Noziel. And Noziel makes the stop on third down, 4:49. The clock stops as Malachi Langley runs out of bounds.
Well, they had Cash Carter alone in the backfield, really trying to sell, hey, we're going to throw it here. We're really going to try to go over the top of your defense. And then handing off on the sweep, trying a little bit of trickery just by scheme and formation there. Didn't work out, but they're getting it closer inch by inch.
Third down and short. Going to throw this one or the attempt and into the backfield for the sack is the Righetti Warrior, the Mission Prep Royals on the Righetti Warriors. And that is Lucas Elmerich, his now with 2.5 sacks on the year.
Lucas Elmerich doing a good job getting into the backfield. Got his hands up first, was trying to make sure that Cash Carter wasn't going to try and run or throw over him. And that hesitation by Cash Carter allowed Elmerich to come in and get the sack. Backs them up in key territory, hard to get territory. A really tough spot for the Warriors.
Third and 10 following the sack. Cash Carter throws. And on the coverage of Ethan Orozco, the pass falls incomplete. Intended for Braden Abba. And it brings up a turnover on downs. I thought that was third down, reading the clock, but it was fourth down, turnover on downs. Happening again.
Well, the Royals will get the ball back here. They've got to be careful. This is ball control 101, no turnovers. That's what they've got to focus on. They're back in their own territory. A fumble here, a bad snap, you name it, the Warriors are right back into this. So it's going to be making sure they do all the basic stuff right. Then you worry about the yardage. Then you worry about the clock. No turnovers is the key for the Royals right now.
21-6. Handoff to Harrigan. And Harrigan pushes forward, trying to get enough for the first down. Vance Abercrombie in on the tackle along with Ryan Twizzleman.
In case of point there, Abercrombie holding up Drew Harrigan while Twistleman was trying to pick his pocket, take the wallet on out, as Twistleman just reaching for that fumble, grabbing all over the arms, trying to wrench it out.
Our sister broadcast, St. John Bosco leading over Jay Sarah 35-13. And that pass thrown out of bounds. And an update from St. Joseph Lompoc into three. St. Joseph 29, Lompoc nothing. And that's all I got for out-of-town scoreboard, Steven.
Well, it's second and short, and that's why they took that little blooper of a fade route there. Hey, you don't complete it, it's fine. They're confident they can get it on this third down, so I expect them to get right back to that ground-and-pound game. Righetti already stacking the box before the huddle's broken, so Righetti expecting it. It's going to be war on the field on this third down.
Trips to the left for Thomas Glenn. And Glenn hands it out to Drew Harrigan. And Harrigan snagged at the line of scrimmage on third down.
Immediate timeout by the Warriors. Smartly taken by Coach Russ Pickett. And it's just a case where Harrigan was trying to follow his blocker upfield, but the defender assigned to that blocker leaked through and got the tackle. No gain.
Immediate timeout is what you said, but I heard media timeout. So we'll take a media timeout. We'll be right back. Mission Prep Football continues on PSN TV.
It's time for an MPG upgrade at Sunset Honda.
Save big with Sunny's end of summer deals at Sunset Honda. Like 3.29% financing for 60 months on select pre-owned Hondas. Or take advantage of $1,250 in Honda loyalty on every new Ridgeline and get 2 years of free scheduled maintenance with any new 23 Honda.
Plus, get a $25 gas card just for taking a test drive.
Trade in your gas guzzler today and get 1,000 over Kelly Blue Book from the start.
Get started today at sunsethonda.com.
My Halloween costume this year is going to be Sunny, the mascot from Sunset Honda. I'm going to see if I can borrow the head. Big red with a big head, looking like a sun. 3:16 on the clock. Because Big Red said so. 21-6 our score. We have the punt unit out. Yes, I made a Stone Cold Steve Austin reference. Steven giving me dirty looks on my reference.
I thought it was 2:16. That's why I was confused.
No, it's Austin,
I misread the situation.
Yeah, it's 3:16. No, it's 3:08. Having to explain things takes time.
Well, there's also an odd flag in the backfield on this one. I'm wondering if it's a run into the kicker situation and they're going to, or if it's a hold and it will be a re-kick. I think it might be a hold and there will be an option for a re-kick. Declined. So the Warriors happy with where that ball ended up, at least relatively so. So they're going to take the spot at the 40 instead of having a move the ball back 10 yards and have the re-kick. So, interesting call by the Warriors. I think in this type of situation, you know, where you have a chance to really go for a full block, maybe you go for that. But Coach Pickett, he's been around the game quite a bit more than me. You know, I'll trust his judgment on this one.
Update out of the Santa Barbara area. Santa Barbara 52, Dos Pueblos nothing.
That's a rough one.
That's why I gave you that score, because that is a rough score. And I knew you were going to go,
Dos Pueblos shouldn't have that big of a gap to Santa Barbara.
Shotgun snap for Cash Carter. He's looking to throw this one. Fires over the middle. And two Royals trying to get to it as Mraz pops it in the air. Vinny or Miles Thompson and Terry trying to get to it. Luke Terry trying to get to it. That would have been Terry's third interception of the season.
A lot of balls nearly intercepted in this game, but no turnovers yet. You know, we had the early one on the Royals' first scoring drive that was right at the end of the first quarter, ended up not going, and a few the Royals' way as well.
Pass completed, and Lucas Elmerich quickly on the tackle to Damian Mraz. And that brings up third down and 10 from the 40-yard line. As his defense continues to come up clutch.
And well, you know, that's a important Hyundai, place to come
Luis
up clutch. That mid-screen, they're trying to take advantage
prep
of the Warriors playing the boundary to get that tackle in the middle of the field and keep the clock rolling is a big deal.
Apologize for the inadvertent commercial play. Pass completed to Mraz. And that's going to be a first down for Righetti. Out to the 20. A nice 20-yard pickup for the offense of the Warriors.
Warriors keeping the tempo up. It's a good pass out to Mraz. Got that room immediately gobbled up, but because it is so well laced between the zone, there's nothing the Royals could do to finish that one out. Just a missed assignment in the zone and a cash in by the Warriors.
Under 2 minutes to go here in the final frame. And the handoff to the man in motion, Braden Abba. Emba with the carry on first down, bringing up second down and seven for Righetti.
They need to have a little bit more urgency than this. They've got one timeout in 90 seconds to get two scores. You know, this is still a winnable game if they are able to execute the most on the time that they have remaining, but they're taking their time.
Cash Carter throws over the middle, looking for Mraz, and Damian Mraz not there in time. 1:17 on the clock. Clock stops with that incomplete pass for Righetti, who, as you said, has one timeout left here in the fourth quarter, trailing by 15. A lot of work to be done by Righetti with 77 seconds on the clock.
Cash Carter took every little bit that he could on that last play to give his wide receiver a chance. The wide receivers aren't getting open. It's not on the quarterback.
And the snap on third down and seven. And Carter still on his feet. He throws this one away. And being chased down by a number of Royals, including Joseph Clipperton and Gabe Rodriguez.
I thought Clipperton had him. He was around the waist, had a good spin, just did not go to the ground. On that tackle, something that, you know, isn't practiced all that much is if you're taking it laterally, you really got to have that lateral takedown ability, drop to the hip as you pull them down. That's why wrestling is a really good cross-training sport with football.
And the Righetti Warriors take their final timeout on 4th and 7 with the clock stopped. You would think they would have this play drawn up in their back pocket. Steven, at some point throughout the year, they'd be in the position ready to do something on a 4th and 7 from inside the 20.
Well, I mean, this is a situation where the coaches clearly felt like they needed to break that momentum. They almost had a sack that would have been disastrous on the last play, and they haven't been getting the correct response that they've been wanting to see out of the players. So you take a timeout here, because if you don't convert on 4th down, that timeout doesn't matter anymore. The Royals are going to have the ball. They can kneel it out. So I actually think that taking the time out there was smart to make sure that they have the right play called and that the players understand exactly what's expected of them on this play. Because if they aren't able to convert, if they aren't able to find the end zone, this is the end of the game.
1:08, 68 seconds remain. 4th and 7. Cash Carter takes the snap, fires, complete for the first down to Langley. And Langley keeps this drive alive with 59 seconds. They stop the clock to move the chains, which assists the Righetti Warriors.
Alex Nerez coming in on a substitution. I'm surprised that they're subbing. I'm surprised that they don't have a signal in at all. This is taking valuable time off the clock.
Damian Mraz trying to get the right play. They got too many men on the field. They got to clear the field before the snap. And the pressure coming, throwing it away. Chet Morrissey on the chase along with Joseph Clipperton.
Yeah, if you're going to critique anything there, you can't be substituting in that situation, because I think that technically may have been an illegal snap because they substituted. Mission is allowed a window to substitute after the offense substitutes. So if you're substituting that close to the snap, that's illegal. The Mission had to have had a chance to substitute before that ball was snapped. That's a few more seconds off the clock there. You got to run with the personnel you got when you're this close to the end zone and the clock is running.
Mission Prep has come up pretty clutch here in the red zone all game long. fires over the middle. That is intercepted. The Royals come up with that ball. They're going to say that hit the turf. It bounced off the turf. A great attempt. A great attempt by Jaden Noziel.
And Noziel almost putting the frosting on the cake there. Has had a fantastic night. Two touchdowns. Almost came away with the game-ending interception. But the Warriors will still have it. They'll still have a chance. Third down. Have a couple tries here, and then they're going to try for an onside if they can get this in. So not over yet. Still all to play for.
24 seconds. 21-6 our score. Fires into the corner. Trying to go for his receiver. That pass knocked away. Falling incomplete. Ethan Orozco in on the coverage.
Goal line fade. It's a popular play call because it's a safe play call. It looks good. It's something that makes coaches kind of feel good, but it's a very low percentage play. Analysts have started to, you know, really run the math on the different routes here at the goal line. And the fade route is one of the worst, but it does set up for other routes underneath. So it's an important part of the play calling package, but not what you want when you need the score.
Fourth and goal from the 7, and whistles are coming. I think Schuster got a timeout in, and he did before the snap. And Steven, this is a 4th and 7 with 16 seconds on the clock. This is either a make it or break it play here, because you're either going to get into the end zone or turn the ball over now.
Yeah, it's 50-50. You know, you either win or you don't. So, you know, just play your best. No, it's a tough situation. And calling the timeout here, same deal as earlier in the drive when the Warriors took their final timeout. Coach Schuster just making sure, hey, here's the situation. Here's what we need from each player. Let's make sure that we're doing these things correctly. Here's what we've seen in the game. Here's what we can't have in this situation based on that. It's the beauty of coaching. When you have a situation like this, this is where it really highlights and is at its finest is, hey, let's take this time, make sure everything's correct. And you can see Coach Schuster, he's electric right now. He's hopping up and down. Can't quite see it on the monitor, but he's energized by this type of situation. This is what really gets coaches excited.
And as we are here on homecoming, I want to say that this has probably been the most full-rounded football game at Spanos Stadium for the Royals, as we have multiple skyboxes open here with a celebration for alumni. And 16 seconds, 7 yards to go. The throw into the end zone for the attempt. Is it good? It is a touchdown. Warriors, that pass completed to number 13, Malachi Langley, for a 7-yard completion with 6 seconds on the clock.
Langley's been pure electricity today. He's been just energizing whenever he gets the ball in his hands, and they've given it to him a lot. Makes sense to go to him with the game on the line. Just a flat route along the goal line. Are they going for 2? Why?
Because that would make it a – they need 2 at some point if they want to tie this game up.
I guess, they missed the first field goal. So, yeah.
So, here would be the point.
First PAT.
And looking for a receiver, dumps it into the corner to Mraz, and Mraz incomplete over the head of Damian Mraz. So, our score, 21-12. Following that incomplete pass on the 2-point conversion, 6 seconds remain in this ball game.
Well, going to be a 2-score game after all. I feel like you go for the field goal on that one. Get the easy PAT before you go for the hard one, unless the plan all along was go for 2 there, and then if you score again, go for 2 again, because at that point your sideline's going to be electric. Play for the win when you're on the road. But ultimately came up just a little bit short. Another tight game for the Warriors. This is a team that has well outplayed their record. If you look across how they've played through the season, this is a team that deserves much more. And unfortunately, they are going to need a win next week to even consider playoffs, as it looks like they'll be leaving this game still with 1 win in the win column.
1-8 will be the Righetti Warriors, falling to 0-6 in the Mountain League. Your Mission Prep Royals improve to 7-2, 5-1 in the Mountain League. And we have an onside kick recovered by Mission Prep. 1 second off the clock. That kick delivered by Andreas Magañan.
Well, that should just about do it. One kneel down, and that will be the game. So Mission Prep going to be on the road next week to finish out the regular season. They'll be visiting the St. Joseph Knights on that border of Santa Maria and Orchid. I think technically the address is in Santa Maria, but very southern tip of it.
Yes. And I see here on the screen, Toonsy believes in the curse. What curse are we speaking about, Toonsy? Please fill us in. We'd love to hear about it. And as time expires, our final score here from Alex G. Spanos Stadium, Mustang Memorial Field, 21-12. And with that win for the Mission Prep Royals, their seventh win of the year, Coach David Schuster improves to 52 wins in his career here at Mission College Prep. The number one all-time winningest coach in football at Mission College Prep, surpassing Chad Henry. Congratulations, Coach David Schuster, in seven seasons, improving to 52-17. The all-time winningest coach in Mission College Prep football history. That information dug up by Darnell Harris, delivered to my doorstep. And Steven, we've been here through quite a bit of the run. I've been here for four seasons now. You're on your fifth season. It's been a great time here with Mission Prep. And this is my second milestone to share with Mission College Prep Athletics. My first is watching Coach Terrence Harris. Coach Terrence Harris collect his 300th career win as a head coach at Mission College Prep. That happened last season with the Royals at Coates Court. And tonight, David Schuster becomes the all-time winningest coach in football at Mission College Prep.
And that's not a small feat, because this is a coach that inherited a team that was playing eight-man football. He brought it up to the 11-man ranks. Now it's up to the 11-man ranks. He's able to climb all the way through the Ocean League, now into the Mountain League, where he's considered one of the title contenders here a couple years in a row. So that's no small deal. And on the field, amazing, amazing success for Coach Schuster. Of course, halftime we talked about how successful he's been off the field, which is just as important. A fantastic coach here for Mission Prep, and someone that has been finding a lot of success in different facets of coaching, as well as other life at Mission Prep. He's, of course, a great videographer for softball, as he sends in all the clips for the local news programs, as my mom always likes to remind me when she sees that on KSBY.
And our final score is 21-12. Mission College Prep pulls out the win. Next week they have the matchup against the St. Joseph Knights. But let's break down the scoring here in this game, as we have the lights turned out on us. Oh, boy.
Yeah, it's the post game. We're after dark.
So late after dark, PSNtv after dark, 21-7 is our score. 21-12 is our score. There, the lights come back on. Starting out, our first score, 11:55 in the second quarter. Jaden Noziel punches it in for a 13-yard score, making it 7-0. Cash Trevisan with the extra point. And then on the next possession for the Royals, on the punt from Righetti, Jaden Noziel takes it to the barn, 81 yards, 9:58 on the clock in the second quarter. Cash Trevisan, extra point good, 14-0 is our score. And in the third quarter, 9:52 in the third quarter, a 52-yard run by Drew Harrigan. The freight train coming alive tonight. Our score, 21-0. Castrovizan, extra point good. And then the Righetti Warriors jump on board into the scoring trend as Vance Abercrombie punches it in 1 yard out. Our score 21-6, the extra point, no good on the failed attempt. And then to finish out the game, 6 seconds remaining, Langley punches it in from 7 yards out. And Malachi Langley makes it a 21-12 ball game. The two-point conversion, no good there. And that brings us to our final. Head coach Mission at Mission College Prep, David Schuster, improving to 52-17 all-time. He is the all-time winningest coach here at Mission Prep. Steven, break down this game for us just a little bit.
Well, you look, the Mission defense was as stout as it's always been. It got a little closer than they wanted to as far as, you know, comfortability goes. Ended up being a just barely two-score game. But offense, coming up clutch, getting the couple scores that they needed. 2 touchdowns on offense, 1 through special teams. The Royals really just doing a good job at the point of attack. And that was really what dictated this game, was who was the low man when. Who was making the correct plays between the tackles. You know, this is a artsman's type of game where it's like, you know, from the outside perspective, is just a lot of big bodies hitting each other, but a lot of technique going into that. And ultimately, Mission Prep came out on top, largely due to those 2 touchdowns by Chase Untall.
And I think it's time for our player of the game, presented by Farmers Insurance agent Jennifer White, who can protect you with your home, auto, and probably multiple insurance options if you give her a call. She'll provide you with all that information, and you can book your appointment with Jennifer White at 805-548-8530. She's serving San Luis Obispo, helping you to protect your property with all your insurance needs. And Steven, I think the votes have been casted. The ballots have been turned in, and I think we have a solid candidate winning tonight.
Yeah, you look, it's Chase Untall. He made some amazing individual plays.
Chase Untall, or are we talking about Jaden Ozeal?
Excuse me, Jaden Ozeal. I said Chase Untall twice, and I wasn't caught. Jaden Ozeal, number 20, is who I'm looking at. It's been a week.
It has been a week.
My Sunday started trapped on a plane, so that was an interesting experience. So just getting out of that now. Jaden Ozeal, 2 long touchdowns, one from the 14-yard line, then the long touchdown from the punt return. Fantastic work. Ethan Roscoe also had fantastic play today as far as the defender goes. And Champ Morrissey as well would have been on that list. You talk about how important the defense was in this game. Those players all doing a fantastic job on that side of the ball, building that iron curtain that Mission Prep has been playing with. That's what is the defining factor for this Mission Prep team. It's unlike any of the other years that I've been here. Just a fantastic defensive team. Not that other years have been necessarily deficient, just it's been dominant this year.
And we go ahead next week with Jaden Ozeal running some things up here this week, building a lot of momentum for Mission Prep heading into next week, a short road trip down to Santa Maria, an even shorter trip for me. It's a 5-minute drive. It's probably about 10 minutes with signal lights. But
yeah, I was going to say, nothing's a 5-minute drive in Santa Maria.
It is a 5-minute drive to work.
Yeah, it would take like 5 minutes. Well, that's impressive.
That is impressive. I'm serious.
In the wrong way, yeah. I mean, I believe that. I was about to say it's a 5-minute drive from Hancock College to the In-N-Out on Stool. So it's like that's just a block or two.
Just to cover it, there's no stoplights. It's all stop signs.
Oh, okay.
So it's quick.
It's consistent, yeah.
Yeah, it's consistent traffic. So next week we're in Santa Maria. We're taking on the St. Joseph Knights. This is going to be for second place in the Mountain League because first place is clinched up by the Arroyo Grande Eagles, who's put in work all season long.
They beat San Ynez tonight. The outside shot for Mission Prep and St. Joseph both was that AG loses out. That'd give them 2 league losses. Therefore, whoever won the St. Joseph Mission Prep game would have been the number one team. But now it's just for seeding and pride. I mean, you talk about pride between the St. Joseph Knights and Mission Prep Royals. The question's not how much is there. It's how much time do you got? You know, the history of Tom Mott and what he's got. You talk about the most northern school in the L.A. Diocese versus the most southern school in the Monterey Diocese. You know, there's a lot of history between these two programs. And it's going to come to a boil next week on the football field down at St. Joseph.
And we're going to be in St. Joseph next week. Join us for the broadcast live here on PSNtv. Coach's show coming up this next Wednesday. We'll talk about this win, talk about Coach Schuster's 52nd win.
52 sounds pretty good, too. I'll take that.
52nd win of his career.
52th.
Becoming the all-time winningest coach at Michigan College Prep. Join us for the coach's show.